you have good participation that way?
The co-op's been in effect about 4 or 5 years. When it first started out, we didn't. This year, I think we got about 6 or 7 kids, which is, you know, up from 2 or 3 that we had when we started the program.
Okay, and tonight's ball game, I know you guys are digging for a victory. This is the first time that you guys have been in the playoffs.
Yes, it's the very first time. Ron Goodwin was our coach for the past 10 years. That was always his goal. We fell a year short after he left, but Chuck Nagel is a first-year coach who is used to the playoff atmosphere. He took our wrestling team to second in state a couple of years ago, so he's used to the atmosphere that goes on around here.
Your football team, is it a young team, or you got some experience?
The offensive line is all seniors. Our quarterback is only a sophomore. He's probably the best athlete in the school, Nate Sams. The sophomore has played real well, progressed all year long. Defensively, we're a lot of seniors also, so we're going to lose a lot of kids.
Okay. I want to thank you for taking time to talk to us, Kevin. I know you've been busy setting this up. And like I say, you guys have done a real good job, and we appreciate the cooperation and help that we've gotten.
Thank you very much. We're glad to have you here.
Okay, very good. We'll be back with a kickoff to tonight's 3A first round playoff action in just a little bit.
Okay, thank you. Yeah.
It's just one.
Okay, we're back here at Sprague Field in Clinton, getting ready with the pregame activities, and we're waiting for the starting lineups. The Clinton band, marching band, is out on the field. Big crowd on hand, a big crowd from Robinson. The Clinton stands are packed. Dwayne
is here.
Is here. And I said a minute ago, I said, hopefully Dwayne Shaw will be here. We'll interview you later and talk about the fires.
They're burning.
I know that. All right, Tony Schrey, the billboard.
Tonight's sponsors, Pat Keene Investment Management and Research, Bob's Pizza, Ron's Furniture, Crawford Memorial Hospital, Crawford County State Bank, Pulliam Funeral Homes, American Legion, E.M. Coulter Post 69 in Robinson, Westgate Red and White, E.H. Berry Corporation, Loyal Order of Moose number 1369, Charlie Incorporated, Goodwine Funeral Homes, Crawford County Insurance Agency in Oblong, First Robinson Savings and Loan, Rural King Supply, Morse Construction, Leaf Incorporated in Robinson, Big Buck Building Center, VFW Post 4549, Dr. David Rotman, Hardee's, Hoagland Chiropractic Clinic, Robinson IGA of the First National Bank of Oblong, Victor Dana Corporation, Victor Products Division, and Worldwide Sound and Video Productions. And guess what? They're behind us.
Okay. The teams are gathering at the end of the field. We're getting ready for the lineups, and we're going to have a lot of competition with the PA behind us.
Robinson defensive unit
to call
will be on the field first this evening for the Robinson Maroons. A defensive back, number one, 6'1", 165, Justin Stone.
I was going to say something, but since
no problem, they're doing it.
Also, the PA back, number 32, a 5'10", senior, 171 pounds, Jim Pat O'Dell. A defensive back wearing number 13, 5'10", 160, a junior, Corey Pritchard.
The Maroons did win the toss and deferred, so they'll be kicking off here tonight.
A defensive back, number 30, 5'11", 165, and a senior, David Bunnell. A linebacker, number 33, 6'4", 212 pounds, Jason Phillips. At a tackle, number 65, 6'3", 299, Bo Davis. At a tackle, number 39, 5'10", 160, senior, Chad Rhinesmith. The nose guard, number 89, a 5'10", 155, sophomore, Jeremiah Whiff. The linebackers, number 56, 6'3", 228, a junior, Aaron Schrey. The other linebacker, number 58, a 6'3", 210, junior, Brent Schrey. And the linebacker, number 20, a 5'7", 150, junior, Dwayne Neely. defensive unit of the Robinson Maroons, the head coach, Terry Roach, and the rest of the Robinson Maroons.
There you got the defensive starting lineup for the Maroons as the Clinton Maroons come out on the field. There's one change from the normal starting lineup on defense, and that's Jeremiah Whiff, who's playing the nose guard tonight for Charlie Applegate.
The offensive lineup for the Clinton Maroons. At wideout, number 49, a 5'9", 140-pound senior, Chad Herzog. The Maroon tight end is number 85, 6'3", 210, and a senior, Ben Nichols. At a tackle, number 79, 6'1", 210 pounds, Jesse Johns. At the other tackle, number 75, 6'3", 200 pounds, a junior, David Limmel. At one guard for the Maroons, wearing number 68, a 5'10", 180-pound senior, Doug Hammer. The center for the Maroons, he wears 52, he's 6'2", 2 1/4", a senior, Kyle Bourne. And another guard for the Maroons, wearing number 67, 5'10", 160, and a senior, Tom Meyer. At a tackle for the Maroons, he wears number 77, 6 foot, 270, and a senior, Andy Curley. Also at a tight end for the Maroons, number 44, 5'11", 185, and a senior, Ben Helfing. In the backfield for the Maroons, wearing number 16, a 5'9", 185-pound senior, is Matt Parson. At tailback, number 35, 5'10", 160, and a senior, Josh Carter. And the Maroon quarterback, he wears number 9, 6'1", 170, and a sophomore, Nate Sam. Ladies and gentlemen, the Ocala Valley Conference, Clinton Maroons.
That's a way to announce a starting lineup.
The head coach of the Maroons,
good job,
Mr. Chuck Nagle.
The guy on the PA is Kevin Wall, the sports information director here that we talked to just prior to the ball game. Does a good job.
Does a great job.
In case you haven't figured it out by now, both teams are the Maroons, and when we refer to the Maroons tonight, we're talking Robinson.
Is this the only two in the state?
No, I think there's a few more.
Two more?
There's one at Dietrich, I know. So
the only one's matched up in 3A tonight, though.
Well, pretty good crowd from Robinson tonight as they made the trip, the 2.5-hour, 3-hour trip over there. This is, as the visitor stands are all full, and we're ready to go. This is what we waited for 9 weeks.
Well, I've been out of touch, and I'm sure you've already talked about this, but what do we know about Clinton? What can we expect?
Well, based upon scouting reports, film, everything, they do an awful lot of running. They're a running ball club like the Robinson Maroons are, and they've got a good backfield, a real strong quarterback who's a sophomore, and they're big up front, kind of like Newton, in that area, as for size that we've faced in the past. They don't seem to be a real fast ball club, but that may change. They have a real big tight end that they do a lot of dump passes to, and they're good solid. They're 8-1. Yeah. It's a good conference.
They seem to be a pretty good match team with Robinson. The Robinson, the one advantage, they're coming in here, of course, with a little bit of experience. The Clinton Maroons, first time to the playoffs. I don't know whether that makes any difference. They're at home, so it's a toss-up.
I don't know. I mean, and a couple of things is Clinton's
our
never been there. One of the reasons they haven't is
Illinois
for so many years, Monticello, who's in this conference,
Bob
also
Avery,
dominated
John
and dominated
Swift,
and dominated, and
Clinton didn't win
the conference. St. Teresa did from Decatur, and then it was Clinton a close second with Sullivan right behind, and Sullivan's playing Newton tonight.
Good representation from their conference as well as the Apollo, too.
Rob, very good.
The Apollo conference had three representatives with Effingham going 4A, and then the Maroons and Newton, and they're both playing up here in the Windy Prairie.
Boy, And it's windy. I tell you what we're going to do also. We got an opportunity right alongside of us here is Mark Bennett from the Terre Haute Tribune. And I've already talked to Mark a little bit tonight, and I said we'll try to steal some stats and then get a chance. We'll try to talk to him a little bit at halftime.
Okay, a couple other things other than the Charlie Applegate substitute. Scott Silverthorne's ankle still hasn't healed from last night's. You can tell I'm pumped up. Last Friday night's game, and Tim Lindsay will be doing the kicking. I think all he has to do this quarter is put it up in the air because I think it'll go about as far as he wants it to.
Yeah, it may fall off the tee.
So we got just about ready to go, Jim.
We got a blimp at the north end of the field. You notice that?
Yeah, but it's tied at the south end. It's blowing that far north.
Yeah. Kicking off for Robinson, number 77, Tim Lindsay.
And we can't hear ourselves think.
Well, we're ready.
Lindsay, ready to go. Wait for the signal from the referee. There it is. Good one. Rolls down to picks
out
it up
about
the
8-yard line. That's Josh Carter.
Good coverage in there by the Maroons.
Joe Ferguson.
I think Chad Reinsmith David Bonnell finally made the tackle there as he was spinning around there.
First and 10.
Clint said Joe Ferguson in on the tackle, too.
I'm going to be quiet because I'll be corrected. It starts on our 18-yard line.
How often we're wrong.
We're about 12 feet from six PA horns.
Huge speakers.
First play, keeper, and that's Sam's
a flag.
He picks up about 6 yards on the play. We'll see what happened.
It's probably a holding the way it came. Where it came from.
It came kind of late. I was afraid it was a late hit.
I was too.
Holding.
Okay, we'll
there
take
we
that.
And against the Clinton Maroons. So that'll be 5 yards walked off. They'll take the penalty.
Let me get in the groove by saying that the restaurant of the American Legion in Robinson is open. When? Thursday, Friday, and Saturday nights for dinner. Sunday for lunch. American Legion, E.M. Kohler Post, 69 in Robinson.
That's bigger than a 5-yard penalty, too.
10 yards, sorry. Sorry. How far are they going to walk that?
Down to the 10-yard line, which will be first and 18.
First and 10.
Okay, Clinton lines it up. A single running back.
Back to pass.
Sam's is going
to
throw it. Got a receiver, but incomplete.
Well, that's going to be tough throwing into that wind.
It sure is.
This half for Clinton.
That was out to Josh Carter,
who
split out wide to the right out of the backfield.
5 yards down and out, and he threw the ball about 20 yards, and it just died.
Look out going the other way.
This is really the key to the ball game, I think, is lack of penalty. I mean, who makes the fewest mistakes, fewest penalties, things like that, because you don't want to get yourself in a hole, it looks like to me, especially against the wind.
Second down coming up. Sam's keeps it again.
Good tackle.
And bumped after a pickup of maybe a yard or so on the play.
Good tackle in there by Chad Rinesmith. Pickup of about, maybe four on the play, making it, I believe,
about third and 14.
Third and 14 from the just over the 14-yard line of Clinton.
This would be a great spot to hold them, force them to punt into that wind now, and that'll give Robinson real good field position.
Let's see what happens. Split right.
Single running back. Sam's looks to throw. Down the middle. Almost intercepted by Jim Pat O'Dell.
Jim Pat may almost made a one-handed, but he almost batted it right into Brett Schrey's hands.
The important thing, that makes a fourth down coming up.
You got it. Let's see if we can get that offense on the line, and let's see what happens here.
Tried to overcompensate for the wind that time and overthrew the ball just a little bit. It was a couple feet over his head.
Yeah, I think kind of. I didn't play quarterback, but to me, you just got to throw it like you normally do and just hope. I mean, you got to cut your routes down a little bit, so we'll see what happens here. This may be the biggest experience of the night, trying to catch a punt or even punting.
Well, he gets off a good line drive. Boy, it hits a wall and stops.
Good job.
Bonnell.
Good job by Bonnell.
Takes it at the...
just outside the 30.
First dog on the stop.
Right where we need to be.
Bonnell on the return.
Watch for some quick hitters by the Maroons here to start out.
Yeah, it's going
to
be placed right almost on the 25-yard line. No, 30-yard line, isn't it?
The Victor Dana Corporation supports all the county athletes in their sports activities and wish them success in tonight's playoff game. Good luck from all the people at Victor Dana Corporation, Victor Products Division in Robinson. People help finding a better way.
Bryant on the first play, hands off to Jake Baxter.
Pickup of about three.
Baxter, the Robinson ball carrier.
Look for the Maroons to do an awful lot of running tonight.
Carson on the stop.
One to get some of those jitterbugs out of there and
Well, that's their game.
Prove what kind of team they really are as Calvin Fox splits way out here to the right. Jake Baxter at the fullback with Jim Pat and Nathan Fiscus at halfbacks with Ryan Bryant at the quarterback. Hand off Jim Pat Odell. Pickup of about four.
Odell, the ball carrier.
Takes a left side, gets a gain of four
Matt
or five.
Carson,
4 yards
tackler.
We'll give him. Third down coming up. Third and let's make it four.
We're in four down territory, so it wouldn't surprise me anything that comes out of here now. Back to Nathan Fiscus for a first down on a delay back on the back side.
Yeah, it's a good call. And
Fiscus
picked up the first down. I think they keyed on Jake a little bit.
Really keying on Jake. I'll kill you, Jim, wrapped up in this cord.
We had everything all sorted out at one time, would you believe? It's a bird's nest.
First down about
were the
18.
First,
excuse me.
Nope, it's okay. I'm having trouble hearing you, too, now.
Jake Baxter. Pickup of about three down
Baxter,
to the 15-yard line. Okay. Handoff, Jim Pat Odell. Not much there that time, but he picked up almost three or four, making it third down inside the 11-yard line with about third and maybe four to go, Jim.
Robinson,
a pretty good size defensive line that they're working with there, so the Robinson offensive line is going to have their work cut out for them. Coming to this side, look at
Fiscus.
There. Nathan Fiscus on a... Had a big hole, took it right straight up the middle to about the 5 yard line.
That'd be first and goal.
First and goal inside the five.
He went out over there between David Null and Mike Manhart over on the right side, David at center, and Sean Odell, and they really did a good job out here.
First and goal for the Maroons. We're first quarter action, 8:20 on the clock.
Jake Baxter
they
up the middle.
Him up.
Yeah, stacked
yeah,
up.
Yeah, stacked him up. Good defensive work on a part of the Clinton Maroons.
Picked up about maybe a yard.
That's
he's down
one of the Maroon tacklers.
Inside the two, about the one and a half.
Back
you like to see him move that yard marker up a little bit, don't you?
Yep.
Second and about a yard, goal to go.
Delay to Jim Pat. Touchdown.
Jim Pat
nobody touched him.
2 yard touchdown run with 7:58 to go.
Need a pencil?
And paper?
Yeah. In your gloves? Let me ask you, was it this warm in L.A.? Look for the Maroons here to go for two as everyone stays in.
And they do. Handoff. Jim Pat pulled out behind
there.
The line. Well, they closed it up at the line of scrimmage. He backed out, looked for a hole, and didn't have any.
Good tackle there by Josh Carter.
Robinson leads it.
With that touchdown, let's wish good luck Maroons in the Robinson IGA branch, the First National Bank of Oblong. They're pleased to help bring you tonight's broadcast. Remember FDIC, an equal housing lender. Wind's blowing my car around.
Hoagland Chiropractic Clinic with Dr. Robert Hoagland and Dr. Todd Hoagland, serving Crawford County for over 25 years, proudly sponsors the Maroons in their efforts toward another great year. Hoagland Chiropractic Clinic specializes in industrial injuries, sports injuries, and workman's compensation injuries. Call Hoagland Chiropractic Clinic in Robinson at 544-2064. Scott. Almost hit Scott Silverthorne. Jim Lindsay.
Oh, muffed.
Bounce balling around. Come on, Maroon.
They're out the 12-yard line.
Good tackle.
Good coverage.
I bet that ball's really knuckling down there the way that wind's whipping.
While they change, let me talk about chainsaws. Now save on Echo chainsaws during the fall sale. A Real King Supply. Get the Echo CS 3000 chainsaw with a 12-inch bar on sale for $199.99 and get a free carrying case for your saw. That's a Real King Supply, Route 33 east of Robinson.
All right, second time for Clinton here. Let's see if the Maroons can stop them again. As Nate Sams comes up under the ball. Goes back to pass over the middle. Ooh! Brett Schrey leaped up there and just about picked that sucker off. He got way up there. Maroons really playing tough D, and that's what's got him here. They've got, what is it, five shutouts or six shutouts, Jim?
Don't ask.
Okay.
I wasn't looking on that one, but I knew what happened as soon as I heard you go, ooh!
It's the playoffs. You know I get kind of squirrely when
Lone
I start
Lone running back.
This.
Handoff right up the middle. A lot of running room. They've got good speed. Let's see if they bring him down right at the 45-yard line.
Good carry by
Matt Pearson.
Pearson, the maroon ball carrier.
Right up the middle.
Pearson, the fullback.
Corey Pritchard on the stop.
Isn't it?
Parson.
Parson, I'm sorry. I didn't. Had a speck on my glasses. Mark Parson.
Okay, brings the ball all the way out to the 46-yard line.
Had a big hole in the line to run through
sure
that
did.
Time.
He
they did a
way
heck of a job.
Over the left or the right guard.
Right.
Option play.
Oh, touchdown.
Touchdown.
It's a touchdown for Nate Sims.
Nate Sims came in and Jim Pat missed him right outside the line of scrimmage and he scampered all the way.
54 yards.
That didn't take long.
Nope.
Nate Sams, the quarterback, and he's just a sophomore.
I'd say you'll look for Clinton to go. I don't know. We'll go for one or two in this win.
.636 on the clock. Both teams have scored here in the first quarter. Right now it's tied up at six all as the Clinton Maroons go after the extra point. And good.
Jeremy Hinton.
That ball went over and then it started coming back. It did. It went way over and then the wind blew it back.
If it had been any higher to blow it back, it wouldn't have been any good.
The Maroons now lead it 7-6.
Okay, let's see what the offense can do here.
We're off to a heck of a start, I tell you. We haven't played 6 minutes in the ball game yet. It's 7-6 score. At Ron's Furniture, you'll find furniture from Corsair, Hillcraft, England, Washington, and others. For new and used furniture, stop in at Ron's Furniture in Robinson, right across from the high school. They're open from 10 to 5 daily, Monday through Saturday.
Clark and Jan Pulliam and the staff at Pulliam Funeral Homes wish the Maroons the very best in the playoffs of the 1993 football season. Good luck, Maroons, from the Pulliam Funeral Home.
Carl Koritz to kick off.
Well, the Robinson Maroons go back on offense to receive a kick for the first time tonight. Well, other than the
this
punt.
This is a dangerous kick because if that ball pops up, just remember it's free.
Right. On
line
the ground.
Drive.
Hey, somebody better
Jim
get it.
Jim Pat Odell picks it up. Right up the middle.
Got
right
a
up
hole.
The middle.
Got a
Look
hole.
Let it go.
Jim Pat has
no
a
way.
Chance.
No way.
All the way. Where'd he pick it up?
I think about the 25-yard line.
That's right. About
you talk
75.
About action.
75 yards. You know, sometimes when they kick that way, it disturbs everything. It disturbs the return initially. It also disturbs the coverage, and sometimes you can step through that first wall and you're gone.
Yeah, and you can just see it opening up from where we were. Well, where were we standing?
Once he blew through that first wave, there wasn't anybody there. Well, with 6:24, that didn't take long.
Ooh.
The Robinson Maroons put six back on the scoreboard. They go up 12-7.
Shaw.
I don't know whether I can stand four quarters of this.
Shaw, can you got enough paper on that pad to write all the scores?
I'm going
in
single space.
Four.
Maroons look a little confused out well, there, so they're waiting to.
First round action of the Class 3A Illinois High School Football Championships here.
Again, the Maroons look like they're going to line up for two as the regular offense is in there.
They set everything up tight. Keeper
Option.
By Ryan Bryant. He goes
in
for the
two-point
conversion. 2 points.
Good job.
14-7.
Ryan Bryant on the two-point conversion for Robinson.
Well, it's 6:24 left to go, and it's 14-7. The defenses have disappeared, and so has the special teams. So we'll see what happens next.
Well, so much for playoff jitters.
Collie just right around the corner. Will your child be ready? Let Pat Keenan Investment Management and Research help you plan for their future. Call Pat Keen at 544-9010. He's committed to your financial future. Member NASD SIPC.
The Loyal Order, the Moose, number 1369 in Robinson, proud of their community and is pleased to be a sponsor of tonight's telecast. That's the Loyal Order of the Moose, number 1369 in Robinson,
good
and we're underway.
Good kick by Tim Lindsay down to about the 8. All the way out to the 30,
to the 30, yeah.
Is number 35, which is Josh Carter. So,
Corey,
we start
to stop Carter on the return for the Maroons.
As the Clinton Maroons start out here at about the 29 or 30 yard line with a little over 6 minutes to go here in the first quarter.
Well, Clinton splits a couple of wide receivers out to the near side of the field. Ben Nichols, the wide out. They go right up the middle again.
And Parsons, the Maroon
Parsons,
ball carrier.
The fullback with the carry, gets 3 or 4 yards.
Good tackle in there by Chad Rinesmith and Brett Shry.
Stop for Robinson.
Second and 7 for the Clinton Maroons.
I'm glad you came, Dwayne, because you were my
windbreak.
We were getting worried.
And Ron's down there. Yeah, it's not too bad over here. Second down and about 7.
Sam's back to throw. Little quick opener
Pass
out to the far
Nichols
side. Play. Falls incomplete.
Ben the Nichols.
Ball flutters.
Yeah, the bit. I think we're seeing why they run a lot.
Well, he's a sophomore quarterback.
Yep.
He's got good foot speed. We just found that out a little bit ago. Handles himself very well. And maybe he throws well when the wind's not batting
yeah, we'll
in
see,
face
we'll
30 miles
here,
an hour.
Yeah, we'll see here in a few minutes when they're going the other direction.
May throw some 60-yarders in the second quarter.
Third down again in 7 for Clinton.
In the eye this time. Sam's back, looks to throw over the middle. Got a receiver.
That was well thrown.
Complete.
Pass complete to Ben Helton.
That's a good throw and good
coverage
by Justin Stone. I mean, he was right there, and he just whipped it right in there. There was nothing he could do.
Heck of a catch by Helton.
Good play.
And that takes the ball into Robinson territory at the 45-yard line. First and 10. Boy, things happen in a hurry up here.
Ooh. It looks like maybe if you throw right into the teeth of the wind, it's better than trying to throw out in the flat.
Handoff again, right up the middle, Parsons.
And Parsons, the Maroon ball carrier.
Give him about 6 yards on the carry.
Good yardage, about what, 6-7?
Yeah, about 7 yards. Make it 2nd-3.
Brett Try and Jim Pat O'Dell on the tackle there. It was David Bonnell, I'm sorry.
Interesting when you match up two clubs like this, it's never seen each other all year long.
And they just go by what's
right.
On film. It's really interesting to see what happens.
Hand off again.
Second man through, Bo Davis.
Caught
Chad
right in the line of
ball carrier.
Dwayne Neely, Corey Pritchard.
Bo Davis on the stop.
Kevin McCleary, I think, was a ball carrier. They'll make that Josh Carter.
Maroons now have a 3rd and 5.
We're kind of in 4-down territory again, and I'd look for about anything here. Short pass maybe to the tight end. You never can tell, but they're really splitting everybody out wide.
They're
spreading the field.
That's called spreading the field, right?
Up the middle. Close to the first down. It depends on the spot.
Dwayne Neely on the stop.
Okay, I was going to say, that's where he went down.
Brought it back.
Yes.
This crowd over here doesn't like that.
But that's
fourth and about
1.
Well, he rolled for the first down, but they put it where his knee touched. They brought it back. Not a very popular call here on the Clinton side.
At this point of the season, if you can't run for a yard, you don't belong here anyway.
That's right.
They don't have
They got the first down.
On the play.
Maroons, the Robinson Maroons too anxious, jumped offside. Take the ball down to about the 30-yard line with about 3.5 minutes to go as Clinton continues their drive.
Well, they did a good job in drawing them off that time because they had 4 of them jumping.
Yep.
1st and 10 for the Clinton Maroons. Again, split to the near side. Ben Helton, Sam's keeper. picks up about six.
Good tackle by Bo Davis and Brett Schrey out there.
Bo Davis on the stop.
You notice they're pretty well staying inside the tackles, not going in until they get way out there. They're staying inside those tackles when they're running the ball. They've got a big line, and they're bigger than the Maroons are up front, except for Bo Davis.
Second and five. Parsons,
oh,
they got
Bo
him
Davis.
If they can hold him.
Yeah, Parsons, the Maroon ball carrier.
Still got a couple of yards out of it.
Good job in there as Bo just blew across there and made the initial stop.
Chad Rinesmith on the stop for Robinson.
And Chad Rinesmith finished him off. I'm glad he helps me. I don't have to worry about it anymore.
Don't have any trouble hearing him anyway, do you?
No, that's not a tornado in the background.
The roar of the wind here in Clinton, boy.
Third down and about three from what, Jim, the 24?
On the 24. Hand off Parsons.
Good job.
Got him short.
Jeremiah Webb.
Well, it's that time again, fourth and short.
Only this time they got a little bit more to go.
Jeremiah Whiff on the stop.
Jeremiah blew through there between the right guard and the center
and
brought the runner down.
Matt Parsons is a 5'9", 185-pound senior for them. Done a good job. Gets off that first step real quick.
This is a senior-laden ball club
with the fourth down play.
Most of the guys going both ways.
Fourth and three. As the Clinton Maroons line it up, they split Ben Nichols out to the near side. Sams looks to throw, unloads it, completes it.
Ooh.
Now, fumble or incomplete?
Oh, good hit by Corey Pritchard.
He stuck him. I'm surprised at the play selection.
So was I, because they should have gone deep because the receiver going down the field was wide open.
Okay, this portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by Leaf Incorporated in the Robinson plant where they manufacture Heath, Milk Duds, Six Looks, and Whoppers candies. That's Leaf Incorporated in Robinson.
The First Robinson Savings and Loan FA is a full-service financial institution with checking accounts, savings accounts, certificates of deposits, and IRAs. That's the First Robinson Savings and Loan FA with deposits insured by the FDIC.
Well, the play goes to the left side.
I believe that was Nathan Fiskus, and it looks like there's a flag on the play.
There's a flag on the far side of the football field.
E.H. Berry Corporation, proud to be in Crawford County and is a strong supporter of the youth of the community. E.H. Berry is pleased to bring you this broadcast. That's E.H. Berry Corporation in Robinson.
Clip from the point of the spot will be, it'll probably be half the distance to the goal.
They marked the spot at 24 or 5 yard line, didn't they?
Yeah.
Clipping call will set Robinson back to the 15 yard line.
When did that occur?
Now they'll mark it on
when
about
did that
14.
Occur?
Right towards the play, but it came from, Maroons in a real spread offense with Jim Pat O'Dell way out to the left and Nathan Fiskus over here to the right.
Both ends in tight. That's Baxter.
Yeah, Baxter.
Baxter. Pick
Baxter
up
about a yard.
Pick up about two or three.
Robinson.
As we're winding down here in the first quarter. I hope they either make it or they punt before the end of the quarter. As we're looking at second and a long 18 yards to go for the Maroons. As the play comes in from the coaches into Ryan Bryant, who crawls under center, who is David Nall, barks out the signals.
Fiskus split to this side. Low
and there's
backfield.
An offside.
There
same formation as last play.
Yeah, I'll jump in with the Crawford County Insurance Agency. They carry all lines of insurance. Call Don Helene, your full-time Pekin agent, at 544-9200 or 592-3553. Good luck, Maroons, from the Crawford County Insurance Agency in Oblong.
All right, they still with the two halfbacks split way out to both sides of the field with the lone running back. They're going to call a flag.
Boy, he airs
He's
it
wide
out.
Open.
Overthrew a little to Jim Pat O'Dell.
It's going to be a legal procedure out here against the Maroons, or they didn't have enough people in the
line
of scrimmage.
Scrimmage, maybe.
Okay, here we go. First one of the night,
call
Jim.
Against Robinson. Yep.
Bob's Pizza offers fast, quick deliveries on pizza. Call Bob's Pizza at 544-3378. That's Bob's Pizza in Robinson at 544-3378.
third down.
Third and 13 for the Maroons. Split to this side. Bryant back again to throw.
Wide across open, wide open. Ooh!
Nathan Fiskus in and out of his hands. And that'll bring up a fourth down play. 35 seconds to go in the first quarter.
That's not the last time we'll see that.
Jake ought to be able to get off a good one.
Should. Look for it to go. If he gets it in the air, it'll really take off.
It could go out of here.
I can't believe they're not that deep. They should be 10 yards deeper.
Well, they may be putting a big rush on. Let's see what happens.
Let's see where he gets it away from. About the 15, probably. Short of the 15.
Yeah,
Maroons still haven't done their shift yet.
Okay, he backs up. He'll be standing on the five right now.
This is a tough play for the center. Good job. Good kick. Look at it carry. See? There.
Oh,
yeah, stay in.
Oh, end zone.
Can you believe that?
That was a 70.
80 yard punt. No, he was on the 20.
He was standing
80
on
yard
the
punt. Boy, that'll help his average.
Standing on the five, kicked it from the 10.
Like I said, we either get a first down or we punt.
That's 90 yards. And it rolls into the end zone.
The Westgate Red and White, with 30 years of service to Crawford County, supports the Robinson Maroons. All the way, Maroons, from Westgate Red and White and Robinson.
Jake Baxter.
Okay, as we wind down here with 23 seconds left.
Terre Haute reporter over here knows all about
Baxter.
Yeah, we're sharing a little information
with Mark Bennett here from the Terre Haute Tribune.
Corey Pritchard.
90-yard punt.
80.
Where he kicked it from the line of scrimmage. Sorry, it's 90 from where he came.
All right.
Officially. Go ahead, hurry.
Dr. David Rotman is your family physician, offering family practice and
obstetrics
at 1008 North Allen in Robinson.
14,
Dr. Rotman is proud to be part of the community, and good luck, Maroons, from Dr. David Rotman as we come to the end of the first quarter. 14-7, Robinson.
Right. I'm picking this up. The Crawford Memorial Hospital and Foundation would like to thank everyone that came out to the surgical and special care wing dedication. This fall, the foundation is off to a great start, and we're at the halfway point of reaching our goal of 200 new foundation members for our fall membership drive. Please help us reach that goal by joining the Crawford Memorial Foundation today. Your membership means a lot. More information, call the foundation coordinator at 544-3131.
Well, after a wild first 6 minutes, it settled down a little bit, but both defenses still look a little shaky here as we roll into the second quarter, as we're fighting the wind and hoping the cards don't fly everywhere.
Oh, well, we gather them up after the ballgame across the state of Alabama.
And if we win, we've only got 2 days to sort them out.
You're right.
That's right. Okay, let's see what Clinton does here to start out the second quarter at second about eight, and see if they open up a little bit on the passing game with the wind at their back.
Well, they split receivers out to the far side.
Hand up off the middle. Way to go. Chad Rinesmith blew in there. He destroyed the right guard as he went across and made the tackle. How come you sit down? Now you're standing up. Third and nine.
Okay, that's what I was checking.
Third and nine.
I was looking at the yard marker.
The Clinton Maroons, as they split two people out. Wide on both sides, split backfield.
Sams is going to throw across the middle.
Intercepted, Jim Pat. Whoop, he's going the other way. He's got it. Good job. Hold on to the ball. Good job.
All right, at the 23.
Jim Pat just sit back there, and you could see he did his job. He's sitting in free safety, and the quarterback didn't sit him, and he just picked it off.
Returns it back to the 23-yard line, and it'll be Robinson Maroons ball with a first and 10, and in good shape.
Victor Dana Corporation supports all the county athletes in their sports activities and wish them success in tonight's game. Good luck from all the people of Victor Dana, Victor Products Division in Robinson. People finding a better way.
All right, let's see if we can get that running game open up a little bit. David Bonnell's back in the backfield now for Jim Pat. Hand off, no. Option.
Keeper.
David Bonnell.
Not much, couple
Bonnell,
of yards.
Ball carrier.
Good job.
Parson and Long on the stop for the Mariners.
David in there as Jim Pat intercepted the pass and is getting a little breather.
Clinton pursued real well on the defense that time as the Maroons strung it out. And Bonnell was able to pick up not much. About a yard is all. Second and nine. Up the middle.
To Jake Baxter, pickup of another couple of yards. Jake's having some rough times up there in the middle, but they keep pounding him in that middle. He's going to break loose sooner or later. One new face out there hadn't been there for two or three weeks, and that's Mike Donaldson. Finally got the cast off his hand, and he's playing wide receiver tonight.
Nathan
Fiskus, and around the corner.
Gets him out of bounds about the first down.
First and goal about the 9-yard line.
Bob Ijams ran him out of bounds.
Nice hole opened up for Nathan then on kind of a cross pattern. Sounds like a pass play.
No.
Robinson, first and goal from the
He went out over there by behind Odell on the line, Sean Odell.
About the 9-yard line.
First and goal. Calvin Fox split way out here to the left. Hand off to Jim Pat Odell, who drives down, picks up about maybe 3 yards down to about
the
6-yard line.
Ball carrier. Hammer on the stop for the Maroons.
I guess they didn't pick up. Down to about the 7, pickup of about 2.
Couple of yards, yeah. Second down.
Maroons are shuffling a lot of people in and out of there. As they're switching, made a couple changes there on the line.
Okay.
Handoff. Jim Pat Odell.
He's down about the 4.
Down the 4-yard line. Third and goal from the 4.
Jim Pat Odell, the ball carrier. Ben Helton brought him down.
This should be a big boost to Robinson's thoughts right here if they can stick in a touchdown against the wind.
Yeah.
Mike Dix just subbed in there, and I don't know who's back in there now. I can't catch all it.
Okay, Jason Phillips.
Jason
back
Phillips
in
just
in.
Cut came in there.
Jim Pat in motion.
Oh, he dropped it.
And I'm not
Clint
sure,
recovered.
But I think
the
Clinton
Clint.
Maroons have picked it up.
I would guess the way it went down.
Big turnover.
The Maroons have the football.
Big turnover.
That's a tough one because he had the blocking out front, and Jim Pat just took his eye off the ball, or the way that wind's blowing, it could have kicked him behind him, and you never know from over in this angle. So Maroon defense has just got to suck it up here and stop him.
Big defensive play and a big turnover.
Yep, when you're down on the 4, that's tough. Good luck, Maroons, from the Robinson IGA branch of the First National Bank of Oblong. They are pleased to help you bring tonight's broadcast. Member FDIC and an equal housing lender.
Sam's back. He keeps it. Pitches out of bounds. There, they got lucky again.
Carter, the Maroon ball carrier.
Well, he got lucky twice because that one offensive lineman out there had his hands full of jerseys right in front of the official and nothing happened.
Nothing was called.
A couple for Carter.
Good job. Good coverage on the pitch there.
You've got a great reason to go to Hardee's. When the competition's over and the name of the game is beating a big appetite, Hardee's has the best lineup around. With mouth-watering sandwiches like mushroom and cheese, Swiss and bacon, cheeseburgers and fried chicken at Hardee's in Robinson.
All right, second down and 8.
I got my sandwiches mixed up a little
bit.
Or
a big 7.
Cheese on everything, no problem. Hardee's has got it.
Back to pass, Sam's.
Ooh. I tell you, there was more white jerseys than red ones over there.
That ball sailed on him that time.
Maroons, after they broke through and scored that first touchdown, the defense has really settled down and playing real solid right now. They've got some real good coverage. They're playing their keys the way they should be and watching what's supposed to be going on. I think maybe the jitters are gone and they're ready to play some football.
Well, it's 14-7 here in the second quarter. Robinson on top. The Clinton Maroons with the ball. In the eye, two wideouts to the far side, Sam's to throw. Airs it out, too far.
Now, are we ready for an 80-yard punt? Because it's about the if I was Jim Pat and David
Robinson.
Bonnell, I'd get down about the 30-yard line and let it bounce in front of me.
It's like.
I'd go back further. They're on about the 45. and the Clinton's going to be kicking from about, the ball's on the 16.
Ben Nichols,
17.
Nichols to punt.
Ben Nichols will be punting for the Clinton Maroons. It's going to be about the same place Robinson
good
was.
Good job.
A good spiraling kick taken on the 45 by David.
Oh, what a block by Jim Pat O'Dell.
Oh, he's fumbled, and Clinton recovered it.
David was trying like heck to get free, and the ball came loose.
Well, the football.
Another big turnover. Don't give him too many chances, and Clinton will have a first and 10 on the 43-yard line.
On the recovery.
On the 38-yard line.
Well, this is the bugaboo that got the Maroons a couple of times this year, and it's come back here. It's been missing for the last 3 or 4 weeks, so it's back up to the defense again.
Well, the defense played well after the other turnover. Now they got to turn it on again. There's Parsons, met at the line of scrimmage. Pickup of about 3, finally.
Parsons, the Maroon, ball carrier.
Aaron Schrey made the tackle. Brett made the first
Aaron
hit
Schrey
on him.
On the stop.
Look for Clinton here to do a lot of running. I think they've, and I may be wrong. I mean, I'm just guessing that they haven't done much in the passing game. Look for him to run the ball a lot. See if the Maroon defense can be stingy.
Parsons on a handoff. He's got a hole. Look at
good
that.
Good job.
Neely.
Dwayne Neely stuck his head right up there in the hole and took
Dwayne
him
Neely on.
Neely on
the stop.
Got a yard maybe, and that's all. Make it 3rd and 6.
About the 44-yard line.
Okay, big 3rd down again here for the Maroon defense.
How we doing?
Looking at 7 minutes left here to go in the first half as the Robinson Maroons still lead 14-7.
Sam's to throw. Airs it out.
Way
too
over
far.
His head.
Thrown.
Pass is incomplete.
That's all right. Be 4th down coming up.
Westgate Red and White, with 30 years of service to Crawford County, supports the Robinson Maroons. All the way Maroons from Westgate Red and White in Robinson.
Dr. David Rotman is your family physician, offering family practice and obstetrics at 1008 North Allen Street in Robinson. Dr. Rotman is proud to be a part of the community. Good luck, Maroons, from Dr. David Rotman.
Okay, let's see what happens on this punt. It's over your head. Let it go. Let it go.
Let it go.
Let it go, Jim Pat. Nope, he's going to take it.
Well, he picked it up at about the 6-yard line and gets it back to about the 10.
If he wouldn't have fumbled it, he'd been just fine, but it just slipped through there. So the offense needs to get that running game going and march down the field here and close out this quarter with about 6:44 left to go.
Now save on Echo chainsaws during this fall sale at Real King Supply. Get the Echo CS3000 chainsaw with 12-inch bar on sale for $199.99 and get a free carrying case for your saw. That's Real King Supply on Route 33 east of Robinson.
A fumble again. Clinton.
Another fumble. The Maroons have recovered a fumble again.
Well, we're seeing shades of Eppingham here. This isn't good. 3 fumbles on 3 possessions for the Robinson Maroons.
Clinton has gained about 70 yards now on 3 fumbles.
Okay, the defense is back out there. They're on the 15-yard line. They've handed it to the Clinton team here.
Well, Robinson at this point leads it 14-7. There's 6:20 to go here in the first half.
From the 15-yard
but they fumbled it away
line.
For the 3rd time in this quarter. Clinton lines
and
up.
And what's the timeout?
We'll call timeout.
This year, the VFW Post in Robinson is working toward their goal of being ranked All-American Post, which would give them a very distinguished honor and national recognition. To reach this goal, they need new memberships. Join the VFW Post 4549 in Robinson now and help them reach their goal.
At Ron's Furniture, you'll find furniture from Corsair, Hillcraft, England, Washington, and others. For new and used furniture, stop in at Ron's Furniture in Robinson. They're open from 10 to 5 daily, Monday through Saturday.
Today's financial world is complex. Let Pat Keenan, Investment Management and Research, help you find out what investments are best for you. Call Pat Keenan at 544-9010. He's committed to your financial future. Member NASD SIPC.
Morris Construction and his employees actively sponsor Robinson High School football games, and they help to fund the new bleachers and press areas. Good luck from Morris Construction to the Robinson Maroons.
All right, Clinton comes out with the ball on the 15-yard line after three consecutive fumbles by the Maroons. See what's going to happen. Hand off
Parsons.
To Parsons.
Not
Parsons.
Much. Whoa, and he squeezed loose and got about four or five more.
He got underneath the Robinson tackler and picked up about 5 yards.
And he's down on the stop.
He's down about the 8-yard line, looking at second and about four. Need a big stop here.
Coming wide as Sam's pulled
good
down
tackle.
From behind.
Right, Jim Pat Odell. Looks
Boy.
Like a first and goal down about the 3-yard line.
Close to the goal.
It's a first and goal for the Maroons.
As Clinton's trying to put in the tying score here with a little over five and a half, or a little less than 5.5 minutes to go in the second quarter.
Well, again, Parsons, a lone running back. Sam's
up
gives it
middle.
To him. He tries it, doesn't get there.
And Parsons, the Maroon ball carrier.
Doesn't get there.
Down to about the 1.5, a pickup of about 1.5 yards. Second goal for Clinton. As the Maroons, the Robinson Maroons, are letting Clinton back in this one.
They send Ben Helton to the far side of the field. They've got Herzog, got a man in motion. Parsons right up the middle.
Touchdown.
Touchdown. Ben Parsons!
Well, it was bound to happen. You give them three chances, they're going to put it in.
All right, let's see what they go for here, whether it's going to be a
They've got
kick.
The tee out there.
Looking for a kick here for to tie the score.
Like Jeremy Hinton doing the extra point. Chad Herzog will be the holder. They get it up.
It's good.
And do it.
Kick is good out of the Herzog hole.
Well, it's all tied up.
If you watch the score
14-0 with 4:37 to go in the first half. And I guess that's what playoff games are supposed to be.
Sure
even,
are.
Even Steven.
Maroons got to hang on the ball. They can win this game. And they let him back in here, and they just got to hang on the ball and move the ball down the field. The Loyal Order of Moose, number 1369 in Robinson, is proud of their community and is pleased to be a sponsor of tonight's broadcast. That's the Loyal Order of Moose, number 1369 in Robinson.
How we doing? Need I ask?
How come you're giving them to me?
Because I can only write with one hand.
Oh, okay. Well, I wonder how far this kickoff will fly. That's the challenge of the night. Deep, should let it.
Down it, right there.
It'll be a touchback.
Doesn't even make any difference on that one. As long as it goes, breaks the plane, it's over.
E.H. Berry Corporation, proud to be in Crawford County. They're a strong supporter of the youth of the community. E.H. Berry is pleased to help bring you this telecast. That's E.H. Berry Corporation in Robinson.
Okay, with 4:36 left to go in the half. Let's see if the Maroons can get it going here.
Now it's time to move the football. Jesse Snyder split out to the near side of the field. Full house backfield, Bryant the handoff.
Oh, Nathan Viscus just about broke it. That play,
him 8 yards.
That play has been wide open all
Chad
night long.
On the stop for the Maroons.
Second down and about one has a pickup of about 9 for the Maroons. Jesse Snyder again splits out here wide to the left. Joe Ferguson's in at a tight end position over on the right, unbalanced left. Handoff, Jim Pat Odell, first down.
Pat Odell, the ball carrier.
I almost thought he didn't get the handoff, mate.
See if Hammer the Maroons can come in here and score here before the half.
Well, they've got 4 minutes to do it, and they can do it.
They know how to play football. They just got to remember. Sometimes they forget once in a while. Jake Baxter. Jake Baxter. Come
There's
on, Jake.
There goes
come on, Jake.
Boy,
look at that.
Right over
it. He
Jake Baxter.
He's going to go all the way. Look at the block out here by Kyle Johnson.
Jake Baxter.
70 yards. 71. Yards. He destroyed this guy on a straight arm.
I don't know who it was, but give him credit for trying to take him on anyway.
One of the things, and I hope Ron got it, was Kyle Johnson came back from the wide receiver's position, was just hitting people all over the place, letting Jake Brennan on in.
Well, how quick it changes.
And now it's 20-14, 3:45 left on the clock as the Maroons look like they're going to go for one. As Jim Lindsay's in
now
there.
They stay put.
Jim Lindsay's back in there at the...
How they keep it. Handoff.
Didn't quite make it.
Shut him out, I believe. 20-14 the score. The Robinson Maroons on top.
Okay.
The Crawford County Insurance Agency carries all kinds of insurance. Call Don Helene, your full-time Pekin agent, at 544-9200. Or 592-3553. Good luck, Maroons, from the Crawford County Insurance Agency in Oblong.
The restaurant at the American Legion in Robinson is open Thursday, Friday, and Saturday nights for dinner and Sundays for lunch. That's the American Legion, E.M. Coulter Post 69 in Robinson.
Hey, are you looking for a new computer system? Are you interested in buying a new laptop? What about computer service and support? If these questions are on your mind, talk to Tony or Pete at Charlie Incorporated, the CI Systems. Call them at 546-5442 or come in and see them on the east side of the square in Robinson. That's Charlie Incorporated, CI Systems, serving Crawford County and the surrounding area for over 15 years.
All right, Tim Lindsay snubs it down to about the
41 or 2.
41,
maybe.
And that's fine.
Well, there's 3:43 to go here in the first half. The Robinson Maroons now lead at 20-14.
Maroon offense on the field, first and 10 from the 41-yard line.
Well, let's see if the defense now can stop them. Then, since the offense redeemed themselves a little bit after those three fumbles, and Jake Baxter, would you call that a rumble?
That's a good word. He rumbled, 71 yards? Sam's on a keeper. Good, squirts away, gets about 4 or 5 yards.
Good run there, but good job by the defense of the Robinson Maroons.
I imagine that was the longest run of Baxter's career, wasn't it? I don't remember seeing him go that far.
I thought his knees wobbled about the 5.
the other longest that I've seen was that screenplay with DeCoin last year in the playoffs. Second down at about a long 5 from the 46-yard line of Clinton.
Lone running back. Gives it to Parsons.
Oh, good
Stopped
job.
After about a yard.
Parsons on the ball carry.
Down there was Chad Rinesmith.
Chad Rinesmith, one of the Robinson tacklers.
Brett Schrey was there. I believe Aaron Schrey was there.
Make it 3rd and 3.
Big play here, big play. We're under 3 minutes to go here in the first half.
The ball on the Clinton 48-yard line. 20-14, 2:30 to go in the first half. Robinson on top.
I think the key here for Robinson is to shut down the running game.
Out of the eye, keeper, Sams has it. Looks to pitch back, slips and falls. Loses about 3.
Jason Phillips played that perfect. He came across, forced him in, and then he tried to go back out, and he slipped down, and good job by the defense.
Bob's Pizza offers fast, quick delivery on pizzas. Call Bob's Pizza at 544-3378. That's Bob's Pizza in Robinson, 544-3378.
They're going for it. They're going for it.
Fourth and about 3 for the Maroons.
This is kind of a surprise to me.
Well, there's a minute 48 on the clock. Now he calls a timeout. He's looking it over. Nate Sams looked it over and called the timeout.
I think they were trying to get a little jumping off sides there.
If they could have got the play away while they're still in deep park.
Good discipline there by the defense.
The Crawford County State Bank is ready to handle all your banking needs. If you need some financial advice regarding loans or trust accounts, they're there to help. The Crawford County State Bank is an equal housing lender and a member FDIC.
The First Robinson Savings Loan FA is proud to sponsor this telecast of the Robinson football games. They wish the Maroons continued success in this playoff season. That's the First Robinson Savings and Loan FA with deposits insured by the FDIC.
If there ever was a group of young men to be proud of, it's Robinson's Fighting Maroons. Goodwine Funeral Home would like to offer their heartfelt congratulations to the Maroons and to wish them the best as they head for a state championship. They are already champions of Crawford County because they have demonstrated more than just athletic ability. Once again, they have shown what good sportsmanship and good citizenship are all about. You have truly made Robinson and all of Crawford County very proud.
Clinton back in punt formation. Drives it high. David Bonnell lets it, picks it up.
At the 12, gets it across the 15, and that's where he stopped.
Down about the, just around the 16-yard line with a minute and a half left to go here. As every punt and every kickoff is an adventure.
What? You're telling me.
I've heard receivers talk about trying to catch a punt in Soldier Field, and it can't be any windier.
I mean, it's windy.
Well, the wind is really playing tricks with the ball.
There's no windbreak to the south of it. I mean, it's wide open prairie, and I mean, it's rolling down through there.
1:27 to go here in the first half as the Robinson Maroons come back on offense. First and 10 from their own 16. Full house backfield.
Nathan Fiskus. Nathan Fiskus.
Breaks for about 15 yards. 12 or 13.
I'd say you may want to watch for the Maroons to use their timeouts now as they get it out of the hole a little bit. That running game's really starting to open up over there on the right side. Jace Woodworth is really opening up some holes along with get everybody's number that's over there.
See Jesse Snyder.
Mike Manhart's over there too.
Split out the far side.
Up the middle to Jake Baxter. Pickup of about four.
Clinton's going for the ball too.
Yeah, that's all they're going for.
Well,
now we got a Robinson timeout.
Timeout for Robinson.
Don't be
coming up at halftime.
Don't be surprised if you see
the M-Squad and the Marching Maroons.
If you see a slant pass from the Maroons, kind of a safe pass to throw because if the ball carries, it'll just take off. And it's kind of – but Coach Roach may play it pretty close here and just run out the clock with that lead of 20-14, and they'll be getting the ball here to start the third quarter. And maybe that's what you want to do. Go down and get another score and open a two-touchdown lead. As the Maroons kind of let the not saying anything mean or anything, but they kind of let them back in the game here. But they turned right back around, and Jake Baxter kind of like destroyed the defense as he busted through. And I mean that line opened everything up for him. And you can't say too much more about the Robinson offensive line.
He looked a little bit like Walter Payton when he stiff-armed that guy, but then he turned back into Jake Baxter, didn't he?
No.
Okay.
48 seconds left to go here in the first half.
Second and six for the Maroons. Ryan Bryant keeps it. Pitches back to
Jake Baxter.
A little room. First down.
First down on about the 45-yard line.
Matt Parson, the stop for the Maroons.
That was possible because a good fake to Baxter, and they covered up good.
Yeah, Jim Pat had some room when he turned the corner down there. Got about 7 or 8 yards.
Another timeout by the Robinson Maroons here.
Robinson again.
Where's the ball? I can't see the mark.
It's on 44. Just on 44. The outside. Yeah, 44-yard line. I think everybody heard first quarter score, Sullivan Newton 0-0.
I didn't. Sorry.
I didn't either.
How could you not hear it?
How did you? Oh.
Trained. Well training. Ron, you're not doing a very good job on the windbreak.
Wheeler's over there on the little platform, bundled up. And I tell you what, it could be a lot worse if it's 10 degrees colder. Right now it's not bad. It's windy.
If it was 10 degrees colder, I think I'd go to the truck.
I just looked up a while ago, and those guys on top of this building they're in pain.
Now, we looked at that and came down here.
I'm proud of you.
Jim Pat in motion.
Oops, Adam there's 5 yards. Yeah, he jerked the ball.
That's going to be a walk-off against the Robinson Maroons, I'm afraid.
I thought they were going to get away with it, though.
Preliminary signal, illegal procedure, Robinson.
Well, it'll make it first and 15, take the ball back to the 40-yard line.
All right.
40 seconds to go here in the first half. Robinson leads it 20-14 in a heck of a first half.
It's been a wild one. Mike Donaldson split out here. As the
Ryan
Maroons go
to
back
throw
to pass.
Unloads downfield to Jim Pat out of bounds.
That intended for Jim Pat Odell is incomplete.
I think he, different pattern.
Good safe pattern, too.
Bob Isaacs on the coverage for the Maroons.
Second down.
I didn't get all the officials, but we might mention it's a crew out of Mattoon. Bob Avery's the
had him
umpire.
Before. Yeah, we've had him before in the playoffs.
Usually a good crew.
Handoff second back through, Jim Pat O'Dell. Good ball. Picks up about six on the play as you're looking at third down.
Gets it back up across the 45 anyway.
A little less than 10 with 20 seconds to go. I don't know if the Maroons will try to go one more time or not.
Well, the clock's running down. They're going to let it run down.
They called a timeout, Jim.
Sorry.
They did. 13 seconds to go. We'll see what happens.
It's the playoffs. You got to do those things like that. You got to make sure you're covered. And as dependable as the offensive line is on this team, we could break it for 50 yards anytime.
We'll
and we've done that already.
Yeah, we break at halftime and reload things around here. We're going to have to come back. It's going to take 20 minutes to recap the first half. We'll take a couple of minutes also and try to talk to Mark Bennett from the Terre Haute Tribune, see some of the notes as he's taken, and let him tell us a little bit about some of the teams that they've been watching. Terre Haute Tribune's done a good job keeping track of the teams in the Wabash Valley this year. And I know I always turn to the sports page on Thursday and pick up the statistics. So they've been doing a good job. First and third and nine for the Robinson Maroons.
Reverse. Look at this. If you go outside.
Kyle Johnson, the ball carrier. A little short of the first down.
Carter on the
good
stop.
Play.
Good play. It was
a good play
ball.
To end the quarter on. They think about that now.
That was good. That was fine. If you could have just got outside
Robinson
a little more.
20-14 to score at the end of the first half. Robinson on top. Clinton, 20-14 to score. The Robinson Maroons on top. And during the halftime, I have cornered Mark Bennett from the Terre Haute Tribune Star, who's traveled all the way over here from Indiana to Clinton. Talk a little bit about the ball game. Mark, your thoughts on the first half? Kind of wild.
It was wild, the first half. I think the only thing that really is sticking the Robinson right now is the fumbles. Everything else seems to be strong, and they seem to have a few more weapons than Clinton does.
Robinson has a lot of weapons. Have you seen him play this year at all?
This is my first time to get to see him play. My wife used to teach at Robinson High School and got to see him play several times a few years ago, and this is kind of a treat. I like to get out and see some good high school teams, and it was over on the Indiana side. It's been kind of a lean year, so this is kind of nice.
Well, you've gotten an eye full here the first half with about everything. 20-14 score already, and the game's just half over. I know if you'd want to share some of the statistics you've been keeping track of back here with us and give us a little bit of idea how both teams have fared this first half.
Sure. For Robinson, the team has 23 on the ground, has 23 carries for 166 yards. Jake Baxter leads the way. He's got six carries for 83. Nathan Fiskus has six carries for 59 yards. And Jim Pat O'Dell has nine carries for 17. Passing, Ryan Bryant's 0 for 3. The Robinson Maroons have been penalized three times for 20 yards, and they've lost three of their fumbles. For Clinton, they've got two ball carriers leading them. Parson has 13 carries for 51 yards, and Sams has six carries for 72 yards. Carter has three for 2 yards. Passing, Sams is 1 for 10 with one interception and has 23 yards in that category. Penalties, Clinton's been penalized two times for 12 yards, and they haven't lost possession of a fumble yet. The team has 22 carries on the ground for 125 yards total.
It's been an interesting first half. The wind has played a lot of tricks. We've got a very strong wind blowing out of the south here. I've been surprised that Sam's has tried to throw as much as he has.
Yes, that's been a real surprise. They haven't had much luck yet, but they seem to be pressing on and trying to get the passing game to work.
Earlier in the year, I think Robinson had a little bit of a reputation for a weak pass defense, but I think they've improved over a period of time. Maybe that's why they're still throwing.
Yes, he's had few open targets downfield, and I think that's the reason they're 1-for-10 and also have an interception. Robinson's linebackers seem to be closing off the middle fairly well, too. They're forced to look for a little bit deeper pass.
Well, I'd mentioned earlier that the Carroll Tribune Star has done a good job covering the Valley this year in football, as they usually do in all sports. You've got guys at other ball games tonight. Marshall's playing. That's close to you.
Yes, we've got people at four ball games tonight, and it's kind of a busy night. It's nice to see the Illinois teams doing as well as they are, and it's kind of a break for us. As I mentioned before, we had a little bit of a lean year on the Indiana side, and we've got four teams with good records, and Robinson's right up there at the top.
I wondered, said earlier, you must have drawn the short straw to drive clear over here to Clinton. It's about 3 hours from where we are.
Actually, I kind of am glad to have it. My wife, as I said, had taught here. I thought maybe she'd make the trip with me, but the babysitting didn't work out. But she hopes to get over Saturday and see him play, and I'm a big Robinson fan myself. I love the people over there, and they were real good to my wife and my family.
Okay, Mark, I really appreciate you taking time and sharing some of the stats with us and talking to us here at halftime. I hope, as Robinson, we hope continues on, we'll see you again. If they win tonight, they'll be in Robinson Saturday with the winner of the Sullivan-Newton game. And last count we had, Newton was up 8-0, I think. I don't remember if that was a half score or a second quarter score anyway. So maybe we'll get to talk to you again.
I'd love that. That'd
okay.
Be great.
Okay. Thanks a lot, Mark. Dwayne, they're putting 3 minutes back on the clock out here. And we can talk a little bit about it. It may take a while to get the first half covered with all the big plays that were turned loose here.
Yeah, it really was a selection of big plays with very few exceptions. Robinson scored first at 7:58 of the first quarter. Lodell went over from 3 yards out, and Fiskus was caught in the backfield for no gain on the extra point conversion, make it 6-0. Clinton answered at 6:36 when Sam broke out with a 54-yard run, and Hinton's kick was good to make it 7-6. That was only lasted about 8 seconds or so, and that's how long it took Jim Pat Odell to run 75 yards with a kickoff return. And Brian carried it in for the two-point conversion to make it 14-7, Robinson at the end of the first quarter. At 4:37, Parsons went in from 2 yards out for Clinton, and Kenton's kick again was good to tie the score at 14. And at 3:45, Jake Baxter rumbled down the field for 69 yards on a big run, and the two-point conversion failed that time to make it 20-14 at the end of the first half, and that's where we are right now with 2 minutes coming up to start the third quarter.
Well, in some of the stats that Mark shared with us here the first half, we looked down and I saw Odell with 9 carries and only 17 yards, but you stop and think, he lost 11 or 12 yards on that fumble. So that's come off of what he may have had. He'd had a bigger batch had it not been for that fumble.
Once again earlier today in the
we've seen both teams,
playoffs,
Robinson with a total of 166 yards in the first half,
3A,
and Clinton with 125.
Was the winner over Evergreen Park, 35-21.
Ought to be exciting.
And in 4A, Tinley Park.
Yeah. Did you learn anything while you were gone, Tony?
No, I was trying to find out from somebody else what was going on.
Was the hot chocolate good?
No, I didn't get any of that either. I didn't have time. Too many lines. I think it's pretty obvious what the Maroons need to do. They're moving the ball. They just need to hold on to it. Looks like Clinton's trying to tackle the ball. And, you know, forget about the wind, forget about everything else. Just grab it and go. And I think that's kind of what everybody's feelings are, and that's kind of what mine are right now. I think we can beat. I mean, I think Clinton's beatable. We just got to play our game.
Well, yeah, at 20-14, you'd like to see a little bigger lead. But really, they've scored enough points to win.
Right. I mean, it's
you just take now what Clinton gives you and keep him out of the end zone. That's
right.
The key.
And I think if we can get 2 touchdowns ahead and force them to pass, that's their weakness.
And it very well could be, I mean, it could be any score, but it very well could be 27-7 right now. I mean, to be quite honest, we fumbled three consecutive plays and went from about the 4-yard line down to the 10-yard line on the other end, right, and they scored. And that's just
7 for them, and 7 Robinson should have gotten.
That's right. And so,
well, as we wait here for the kickoff here in the second half, I take this opportunity to mention the sponsors again, the job that they've done with us this year, the fact that we've had a full season of really good sponsors that have been loyal to us. And you people out there, when you go into some of our sponsors, be sure to tell them that you've enjoyed the ball games and watched it on Triax Cable Vision Channel 12.
All right, now Clinton will be kicking off to the Maroons, and they'll be kicking, they'll have the wind to their back, which means the Maroons will have it to their back in the fourth quarter. So, as always, that first series of in the third quarter is real important, and that's what the Maroons need to come out here and show them who's boss, as Jim Pat O'Dell goes deep for the Maroons along with Calvin Fox and David Bonnell, with Jason Phillips in the Jason Phillips on one wing, Joe Ferguson on the other, and then right down the middle is Jake Baxter.
I like the last play of Robinson Ryan at the end of the second quarter, the reverse. They haven't shown that yet, and that gives Clinton something else to think about.
That's right. They got to think about everything. Let's see where the kickoff goes.
Kyle Koritz will be doing the kicking for Clinton as we start the second half.
Squibs it down.
Uh-oh. Jim Pat picks it up at the 5-yard line.
Comes up the middle. Good job.
Puts his head down and takes it to the 15.
It's all right.
To the 15, Van Helton on the stop.
The Victor Dana Corporation supports all the county athletes in their sports activities and wish them success in tonight's game. Good luck from all the people at Victor Dana Corporation, Victor Products Division in Robinson. People finding a better way.
And the wind hasn't let up at all at halftime.
We did get a report from the Robinson filming crew up on top of the building that it is cold.
I couldn't understand how cold he said it was, though. I don't know.
Okay.
Hand off, backs
laid.
Nathan Fiskus.
Yeah. Almost 10
he
yards.
He stepped past that last guy. He had a
Robinson
field.
Ball carrier.
The ball, that play has really been there on that right side. There.
First down.
I'm trying to catch everybody that's in there on that right side right now.
The ball will be at the 26-yard line with a first and 10 for the Maroons as they
start off with a good running play. Hand off, Jim Pat O'Dell. Look at that. Up about 8 yards.
Ball carrier.
Behind the blocking of Jace Woodworth.
Second and 7, a pickup of 7 on the play.
Jace Woodworth, Brian Lockhart on the left side.
Second and 3, a pickup of 7 on the play.
David Null there at center. I think Mike Manhart's at the right guard and Sean O'Dell at the right tackle.
They keep everybody in tight. And that.
Now there's
jump
a first down.
Penalty flag. Once again, the 50-50 drawing number was 244.
Dr. David Rotman is your family physician, offering family practice and obstetrics at 1008 North Allen Street in Robinson. Dr. Rotman is proud to be a part of the community. Good luck, Maroons, from Dr. David Rotman.
First down, 38-yard line for the Maroons. Handoff.
Right side.
Look at Nathan Fiskus dig down. First down.
First down again.
Right at the 50-yard line. Nathan's really running hard tonight, and he picked up another 11, almost 12 yards as we're on the Maroon.
Fiskus, the Robinson
ball carrier. The 50.
Adam Long on the stop.
And the 51.
First down. Near the midfield stripe for Robinson.
Thanks.
Jake Baxter.
He had me fooled.
Baxter.
Jake got a couple of yards.
When they run that option.
Matt Parson on the stop
and,
for the Maroons.
Ryan Bryant really carries out his fakes well, and they all do. And we couldn't hardly tell with the back to us.
I kept waiting for him to pitch it back.
Second down and about 7. Pickup of 3 on the play by Jake Baxter. We got an unbalanced line right.
Jim Pat O'Dell.
Yeah, motion penalty flag
motion
on
penalty
the
on the Maroons.
Yeah.
line moved.
Yeah.
To the far side.
On the far
side.
Well,
he got the first down, but the
it's going to come back.
Penalty's going to
preliminary signals,
walk him off and
call
put him back
Robinson
on the wrong side of the 50 again.
Good luck, Maroons, from the Robinson IGA branch of the First National Bank of Oblong. They are pleased to help bring you tonight's broadcast. Member FDIC and an equal housing lender. Is it getting windier? Okay, 5-yard procedure call against the Maroons, which will bring up a second and about 12 for the Maroons back at about the 48-yard line.
Handoff,
Fiscus. Pickup of about 3, maybe 4 yards.
Now the ball's
pick up
right
about,
on the 50.
About 3. That makes 3rd and 10.
Stop for the Maroons.
Joe Ferguson in there at tight end. They shift Jace Woodworth to the right side, unbalanced to the right now.
Taking an awful long time.
Yeah,
now, there it is.
Now there's a timeout.
Robinson will ask.
Well, the VFW and Robinson's done a lot for Crawford County. Last year, they gave over $57,000 in contributions to local veterans and community projects. Your membership dues help to make this possible. Sign up now at the VFW Post 4549 in Robinson.
Win or lose, you've got a great reason to go to Hardee's. When the competition's over and the name of the game is beating a big appetite, Hardee's has the best lineup around. With mouth-watering sandwiches like mushroom and Swiss, bacon, cheeseburgers, and fried chicken, Hardee's and Robinson.
Now you can save on Echo Power Blowers during the fall sale at Rural King Supply. Get the Echo PB1000 Power Blower for just $149.99 and get a free 2.5-gallon gas can and a bottle of two-cycle mix oil. That's at Rural King Supply on Route 33 east of Robinson. Third down and 10. Big play for the Maroons. Opening drive of the second half.
He keeps and looks to throw. Down the middle, airs it out to Ferguson.
There
well, I think everybody's feet got tangled up. The pass was right on target, though.
Hydrickson long back there on the coverage.
Fourth down
pass
as the Maroons go
Joe
back.
Ferguson.
As Jake Baxter goes back into punt formation.
Yeah, that was into the wind, and Ryan got a good pass away. Joe was well defended. Jake will be punting into the wind.
Good snap.
From the 40, he kicks it.
That's away. Better roll.
And it's going to roll out of bounds, or it's going to be downed inside the 30. We'll put
about
it on the 28.
Clinton Maroons will
keep waiting.
I
keep waiting
in
some punt situation yet this year. Instead of going in the shift, we're going to get a short snap, and somebody's going to run for a first down.
I was waiting for that one. That's
kind of
what I was thinking.
Yeah, yardage is a little bit long for it. If it had been a little bit shorter.
At Ron's Furniture, you'll find recliners, sleepers, and other top-quality furniture at reasonable prices. They're open from 10 to 5 daily, Monday through Saturday. That's Ron's Furniture in Robinson. Handoff.
Josh Carter busted outside.
Carter,
the ball carrier, yeah.
About 8 yards as Jim Pat O'Dell came up to make the stop.
David Bunnell and Jim Pat O'Dell on the stop.
Second down and a long 2, maybe 3.
Third quarter here in Clinton. The Robinson Maroons lead at 20-14. Hand off again to Carter. Finds a hole and's got a first down up to the 40-yard line.
Yeah, he improvised a little bit and made it work.
First down.
Maroons had a good coverage out there on the outside. He cut it back up in there and picked up the first down.
Richard on the stop.
First down at about the 40-yard line. 7:50 to go here in the third quarter. As the this is Clinton's first possession of the second half as they try to tie the ball game back up.
In the eye, Sam's handoff first man.
Good
gets
stop.
A couple of yards,
Justin
and that's about
Stone
all.
One of the first Robinson defenders
Brett Schrei made the initial stop and then brought him on down with lots of help from Chad Grindsmith and Justin Stone.
give him a couple of yards on the play. Now he moves that yard marker up. Every time I say that, they always pick it up and move it a yard. Second and seven. The ball at the Clinton 43. In the eye,
back to pass.
Sam's to throw it.
Pass intended for Ben Nichols is incomplete.
Jim Pat O'Dell was ahead, and Dwayne Neely had good coverage out there on Nichols as he went out on from the tight end position. Clark and Jan Pulliam and the staff at Pulliam Funeral Homes wish the Maroons the very best in the playoffs of the 1993 football season. Good luck, Maroons, from Pulliam Funeral Homes. Okay, big third down here for Clinton and for the Robinson Maroon defense as they split three people wide to the left with a single back.
Sams keeps
fake.
It.
Good coverage. Good coverage
right
by the Maroon defense.
A couple of yards and that's all for Nate Sams, and that'll be a fourth and five. They'll have to kick it away.
Good job by Jeremiah Whiff and Brett Schry and Justin Stone as they stayed right at home and did their job and forced Clinton here to punt 80 yards.
Probably in and out of the ends.
What a terrible thing to have to do.
I'm really nervous about these punts. I don't know. This wind is so tricky. It's hard telling what it'll do, and especially for receiving down there, you just don't.
Ben
you know.
Nichols kicks it away.
And you let it
forget
go.
Him.
Jim Pat's
going
to take it.
At the seven. Well, got
Odell
some running
return.
Room and gets it back out to about the 18-yard
Meyer
line. So
he's been back there for 3 years, so I'll be quiet
okay.
now. But he did a good job and brought it out.
Well, he handled that one very
yards.
Well. What I was afraid of is the way his foot slipped. I thought he was going to go
down
to
a knee,
and I thought, oh.
Whether it's retirement planning, college planning, or just investing in your future, let Pat Keenan Investment Management and Research help you achieve your goals. Call Pat Keenan at 544-9010. He's committed to your financial future. Member NASD SIPC.
Well, the Maroons were the first and 10. Whoops, a little mix up in the backfield.
Nathan Fisk is still driving.
Yeah, no, Jake Baxter, I think, with the ball.
I thought it was Nate.
Now, Nate's over here on the side. That may have been Odell. We may have been wrong all the way around.
Okay. We won't say another.
See who gets up. I think it was
Jim
Odell.
Jim Pat Odell. The
he shoved everybody for about 4 yards.
Cameron Curley.
Him and Ryan ran into defense. Each other, and he still picked up 4 yards.
Well, they split Jesse Snyder out to the near side. Keep the backfield full. Uh-oh.
Fumble. Ryan picked it up.
Kind of a
some confusion
play,
there, yeah.
Yeah, that's two in a row.
That's scary.
Ryan, the ball carrier, yes.
Well, third down, no gain on the play, so it's still third and seven.
But we're losing yards.
Yeah, we are.
We need a
first
down.
We need a
first
down.
We really need a first down here.
Ball on the 22. And not much. A couple of yards, and that brings up a fourth down. And the Maroons will be kicking into the wind. A little over 5 minutes to go here in the third quarter. And Jake Baxter will be punching it straight south into the wind.
Well, maybe we can catch Clinton on the shift here and pick up five easy ones.
Except we need six.
Man, do it again.
Yeah. Low snap.
Hurry,
he's
hurry.
Got time, though. Gets away a low kick. Get a good bounce.
Good job.
It'll go to the 50.
Thank you.
Boy.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Yes. Come out of that.
For the Maroon offense, that's the midfield strike.
Loyal Order and Moose, number 1369 in Robinson, is proud of their community and is pleased to be a sponsor of tonight's broadcast. That's the Loyal Order and Moose, number 1369 in Robinson.
Morris Construction and his employees actively sponsor Robinson High School football games and help to fund the new bleachers and press areas. Good luck from Morris Construction and all the crew with Kenny Matzey.
Sams keeps it. The throw, airs it out long, long.
Well,
that's all it takes.
Herzog!
50-yard play.
Herzog got behind his defender, and that ball was perfect right into his arms.
Yep, good pass. Okay, important extra point here for Clinton.
Well, that ties it up at 20 all. 4:14 on the clock here in the third quarter. And Clinton, as Tony said, with that all-important extra point. 4 points.
Who was the receiver on that play?
Herzog.
No. No.
The hit and kick out of the Herzog. Right. The hold is good, and the Marines lead Robinson
21-20.
21-20.
Well, I'm sure you could hear the PA announcer. Clinton 21, Robinson 20.
All righty. E.H. Berry Corporation is proud to be
it's
in Coffin Canyon.
It's officially a 50-yard pass from Sam Sturzog.
A strong supporter of the youth of the community. E.H. Berry is pleased to help bring you this broadcast. That's the E.H. Berry Corporation in Robinson.
Well, the First Robinson Savings and Loan, FAA, is proud to sponsor this telecast of the Robinson football games. They wish the Maroons continued success for this football season. That's the First Robinson Savings and Loan, FAA, with deposits insured by the FDIC.
All right, let's see if that offense can get going here. We got 4:14 left in the third quarter.
Well, if we hold a form, it won't take long.
No. It's been big plays tonight.
21-20 here in the third quarter. Clinton on top by one, and it's been a wild one so far tonight. And boy, he kicks that one out of everywhere.
It'll be a touchback.
The Maroons will put it in play with a first and 10 on their own 20.
Crawford County State Bank is ready to handle all your banking needs. If you need some financial advice regarding loans or trust accounts, they are there to help. The Crawford County State Bank is an equal housing lender and a member of the FDIC.
Well, we go back to playing football here.
Well, we got to get some first downs. We're going against the wind. That's what you got to do in this kind of weather. Got to get that line moving and get some yards.
In the eye this time. Quick snap, handoff.
Jim Pack. Good running.
Well, I'm
good,
not you.
Kyle Bourne.
There's some seniors back there that don't want to lose. That's 8 yards. And he earned those last four in big time.
Jim Pat Odell, the ball carrier.
Second and two. Pushes the ball up to about the Robinson 27-yard line.
Jason Phillips comes in here at a tight end position over on the right-hand side.
Full backfield, handoff Baxter. First man, Jake Baxter. Doesn't get much.
Jake Baxter met at the line of scrimmage.
They blew the whistle. Yeah.
Blew the whistle.
He is down on the play. Parson on the hit.
It'll be third and two. Well, not much of a gain on the play, if any.
Okay, this is an awful big third
big
down
third
for
down.
The Maroons. They need a first down. They need to get out of the hole a little bit and run some clock off of this, run some time off the clock. Nope.
Well, not much again. I tell you, that Clinton defense has really stiffened up.
Herzog led the Maroon defensive charge.
They ran Fiskus to the right side that time. This time it didn't work so well. Well, that big play for Clinton, and now a 1-point lead has sure pumped them up. Baxter back will be kicking into the wind again, and Jake will be kicking from about his own 15, about his own 20. Again, a low snap. Gets away a good kick this time. Dies in the wind, though. And they'll down it at the 42-yard line. And that's where Clinton will take it over inside Robinson territory with a first and 10. And the ball's going to be placed on the 44.
Bob's Pizza offers fast, quick delivery on pizzas. Call Bob's Pizza at 544-3378. Bob's Pizza in Robinson, 544-3378.
Look for some passing. They got the wind at their back. They might as well go for it.
Sam's back to throw. Airs it out along the other way. In and out of the hand.
For Van Helton.
I tell you, that one had big yardage
on it. On the cover.
Also had Stone's number on it, too, and he was close to picking it off as it bounced away. I'd say if I was Clinton, I'd throw. I mean,
I think they're going
got,
to.
They've got the wind at their back, and they'll probably run a draw now. But
Sam's keeps. Option got away just in time.
Carter on the option.
Good hit by Aaron Try on the quarterback. Sam's made a pitch at the right time, picked up about 8 yards, 9 yards, as to make it third and one.
That was very nearly a four.
Run offense face with a third and short
barely
line.
Got it away. Barely got it away. Well, the Maroons looking for a big play on defense here. Third and a yard. The ball at the 35-yard line.
Sam's on the quarterback keep.
First and 10 for Clinton.
Down about the 31 with a minute and a half left to go here in the third quarter.
It'll be a Maroon first down.
Defense has just got to suck it up.
Ball is resting at the 31-yard line.
Just play basic and hit hard. The defensive backs have got to watch their zones because they're going to come out here and throw again.
Sam Parsons.
Good job.
And Parsons, the Maroon ball carrier.
Good job by Chad Ryan-Smith in there, picking up as he held on there and only allowed him to pick up about 3 yards on the play.
Make it second and 7. The ball on the 28, we'll say. Carter, drug down.
Good job. 25-yard line.
David Bonnell made a great play on there.
Bonnell on the stop.
Third down and about 3.
If he turns that corner and gets past there, it's gone. He's to first down, probably a touchdown.
The ball on the 24.
Third down and a short 3.
Another big play for the Robinson Maroon defense. I mean, you could look for anything here.
Parsons, keeper, Sams.
First down.
Inside the 20.
It's a first down for the Maroons. Neely brings him down.
Inspired ball. They're playing
real good.
They're really pushing.
Their line's doing the job up front, and that's what you got to do to win football games in the playoffs. You're going to pass.
Herzog's put to this side. They're going
that
to the end zone.
Pass is incomplete. The corner will come to a close.
Jim Pat almost intercepted, but that ball just took off in
the
air.
After 3 periods of play, the Maroons 21, Robinson 20.
Is it time for a new computer, monitor, printer, or upgrade your software? If so, let Charlie Incorporated, CI Systems, help find out what is right for you. They have been providing Crawford County with major brands of computers and printers, as well as computer service and support for over 15 years. Number to call is 546-5442 or stop in on the east side of the square in Robinson.
Now you can really save on Benjamin Moore Paints at Big Buck Building Center in Robinson. Regal Wall Satin Latex Interior Flat Paint is normally $17.55, and it's on sale now in over 1,600 custom and ready-mix colors for only $15.80 a gallon. For a beautiful matte flat finish, or you can choose Enhance Vinyl Latex Flat Paint for a fade-resistance flat finish that dries in 1 hour. It's regularly priced at $11.65, but it's on sale now for $10.49 a gallon. Save with Benjamin Moore Paints, on sale now at Big Buck Building Center in Robinson.
Okay, big series, second and 10 for the Maroon defense. They need an awful good stop here. They can't let them score.
Well,
at
the third quarter,
at least not a touchdown.
Was a 7-0 win for Clinton. Robinson didn't get on the board. Handoff, Herzog, or Carter again.
Carter, the ball carrier.
Pickup of about 4 on the play, making it 3rd and 6 as we start out here in the fourth quarter.
Shry brings it down, Aaron Shry.
Defense has got to play inspired right here. They still got lots of time, and they've got the wind at their back, and they can go for it.
That'll be a big advantage this quarter now, with Robinson having the wind at their back, I think. The wind sure hasn't died down any here tonight. Sam's back to throw, being chased, gets it away.
Pass is incomplete.
Good rush in there by Aaron Shry, Chad Ryan-Smith, Jason Phillips, Jim Pat Odell just about intercepted it. I'm guessing they'll go for it. We're looking at 4th and 7. This could be the key point in the ball game for the Maroons.
Very well, could be a turning point here.
Looks like they're going to go for it, crowd.
Well, Clinton splits Chad Herzog out to the far side. Sam's back. He looks to throw, and he's looking down the middle. And he's
good
bottled
shot.
Up
yes.
The Maroons at
Sam
the 20. Big play. Big play.
Great. Good pursuit by the line and the linebackers, but a good coverage downfield.
Great coverage downfield.
Well, they got through and pressured him on the play before, and they didn't let up any at all this time.
All right, let's see what the offense can do because it's in their hands. 11-13 to go. Lots of time in the fourth quarter. We're only down by one.
80 yards in front of them and lots of wind behind them.
Jason Phillips is getting helped off field there.
Will now come onto the field.
Maroons, first and 10.
T. Up the middle to Jim Pat.
5 yards.
Don't have to get it all at once. Just
ball carrier.
Good fundamental.
On the stop for the Maroon defense.
Aaron Tries in there now at right guard. At right tackle is Sean O'Dell, who shifts over to the left in an unbalanced situation left. Play comes in from Coach Reardon or Coach Riker as Ryan gets underneath the center, David Nall.
Donaldson split out to the far side. And Ryan Bryant pitches back.
Good job.
Nathan Fiskus, I think, is the ball carrier and a first down.
Boy, he waited a long time to make that pitch. I thought it was too late.
Fiskus, the ball carrier.
They take it up close to the 34-yard line, let's put it.
Fiskus was right where he needed to be.
Timeout. They're going to have
That's
to use a timeout.
Robinson will take a timeout.
Well, win or lose, you've got a great reason to go to Hardee's when the competition's over and the name of the game is beating
Robinson
a big appetite. Hardee's has the best lineup around with mouth-watering sandwiches like chicken filet, roast beef, fisherman's filet, and Hardee's famous Big Deluxe. That's at Hardee's in Robinson.
The Victor Dana Corporation supports all the county athletes in their sports activities and wish them success in tonight's game. Good luck from all the people at Victor Dana Corporation, Products Division in Robinson. People finding a better way.
Good luck, Maroons, from the Robinson IGA branch of the First National Bank of Oblong.
We are
pleased to help bring you tonight's broadcast. Remember, FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Tied at eight.
Okay.
Get that?
Yeah, 8-8, Newton and Sullivan. Kind of like this one.
Well, this one's not so good. 21-20, Clinton on top by one. Still got 10 minutes to go here in a ball game, and the Maroons have got it with a first and 10 on their own 34-yard line.
A little different set here for the Maroons as Nathan Fiskus goes in motion. Hand off up the middle to Jake Baxter.
Jake's got room.
Jim Pat O'Dell.
Come on, Jim. It's a foot race.
Yes.
Well, we said it didn't take
Jim
long.
Jim Pat O'Dell for the touchdown.
66 yards.
That messed me up. I missed it all the way. Way to go. Back, it was an inside handoff. Had to be back to Jim Pat O'Dell, who came around to right in kind of in a delay.
Well, he came across and cut back out.
And he turned a corner.
Boy, he did.
26-21. Another big extra point. Look for the Maroons to go for two.
Well, right now, it's a five-point ball game, and that two-point conversion would sure make it big.
Ryan Bryant
to throw. They've got Jesse open. Oh, across the middle to Jason Sexton.
Yes!
Stone, and it's complete. Touchdown.
All right.
Touchdown.
Blew the mic away there, Ron.
Snyder came open. Ryan looked at him and then saw Jason, or Justin. I'm having trouble with that one.
Jake. He saw Jake. Jake came out of the backfield over, and then he looked back to... Was it Jesse that caught it?
No, Justin Stone.
Justin Stone caught it. We're really messed up. All right, 28-21, 10 minutes to go.
We just mentioned the whole offense.
But it's worth two, and that's a big two. Now it's a seven-point ball game.
And I don't get excited at these games. It's
28-21.
So after everybody adjusts their volume on their TV, because I blew it away just then.
And now you can save on Echo Power Blowers during the fall sale at Rural King Supply. Get the Echo PB1000. Yes, PB1000 power blower for just $149.99 and get a free 2.5-gallon gas can and a bottle of two-cycle mix oil. That's at Rural King Supply, Route 33, east of Robinson.
Tim Lindsay to kick off. Let's get one way down there and out of that end zone.
Pin a game of big plays. I've never seen so many big plays. Well, momentum shifts. Maroons with the wind at their back.
It shifts with the wind.
Oh, it does.
Poetic.
Oh. Tim Lindsay on the ball.
High
pops
and short.
There's the ball
taken. Ooh. Let's see. Oh, my. Pile up at the 27-yard line.
I think Clinton picked it up.
I think they did.
Boy,
they
it
covered
was close.
It.
The VFW in Robinson has done a lot for Crawford County. Last year, they gave over $57,000 in contributions to local veterans and community projects. Your membership dues help to make all that possible. Sign up now at the VFW Post 4549 in Robinson.
Clinton Maroons break the huddle with a first and 10. The ball on their own 27.
9:59 to go.
Sam's keeps.
That's
pull
the
down. Good
that's
defense.
The play you ran 51
up.
Yards for.
Jeremiah Whiff, the sophomore, broke through and great play.
Whiff has played a good ball game. Made his presence known very well there. That was big play.
He has played. He's been a force all year on the sophomore team, and he's really stepped up tonight when he had to step up.
A loss of about 5 yards. It'll be second and 15.
From about the 22-yard line.
Carter in motion.
Watch your inside reverse.
Coming this way.
Yeah, Herzog, the ball carrier.
Just about fumbled it. We had a good shot of that one.
He was carrying it on his shoulder when he turned the corner.
Yeah. Good play.
Brings it up across the 30.
Maroons have played, there's big plays and they're going to happen, but the Maroon defense have basically stayed at home and played fundamentally sound. As we're coming up with a 3rd and 4, with 9:10 left to go here in the third quarter.
The ball on the Clinton 33.
And now every play's a big play, so I'm not gonna say big play anymore.
In the eye, Sam's got it, keeps it. Ducks inside, doesn't go anywhere.
Good job, defense.
Fourth down.
Sam's the ball carrier.
And they can kick into the wind.
Dr. David Rotman is your family physician, offering family practice and obstetrics. 1008 North Allen Street in Robinson. Dr. Rotman's proud to be a part of the community. Good luck, Maroons, from Dr. David Rotman.
Okay, watch for a fake. Watch for anything. Fourth down.
Fourth and 2. The ball on the 35-yard line of Clinton. They show punt. They got to kick it.
They almost have to right now, but watch that short snap. Nope.
Gets it up. Good kick.
Fair
good
catch.
Job.
Fair catch signal.
Good hands, Jim Pat.
All right, Jim Pat Odell.
First and 10 on the 43.
At Ron's Furniture, you'll find lamps, recliners, dinettes, and good used TV sets. Ron's Furniture is open 10 to 5 daily, Monday through Saturday. It's Ron's Furniture in Robinson.
Well, the Robinson Maroons offense needs to come out here and do it again.
Clark and Jan Pulliam and the staff at Pulliam Funeral Homes wish the Maroons the very best in the playoffs of the 1993 football season. Good luck, Maroons, from Pulliam Funeral Home.
Okay, Maroons back over the ball. Handoff, Jim Pat Odell.
Got a hole. Back to the 50.
Jim Pat is on a mission right now.
Yes.
Last year he got hurt in that Georgetown game, the first game of the year, and he's this second half he's come alive and he is really running hard.
Yeah, he missed a lot of football last year. He's wanting to play some now, isn't he?
There's 8 minutes left here to go in the fourth quarter.
Baxter up the middle.
First down, or real close.
Baxter is the ball carrier.
Retiring from your job, moving on to a new one. Let Pat Keenan, Investment Management Research, help you with an IRA rollover. Call Pat Keenan at 544-9010. He's committed to your financial future. Member NASD SIPC.
Pat Keenan won't mind if I jumped in there with a first down in the middle of that.
That's okay. Pat won't mind at all.
Not at all.
Jim Pat O'Dell.
Boy. For about six or seven.
O'Dell, the ball carrier.
Let's just do this.
Spotted on the 43.
Carlton Herzog on the stop.
About two plays a minute.
Yeah. Don't do anything fancy.
Just walk right down the field.
Just keep going.
And hang on. Cover that ball.
Watch those guys up front because they're really doing a job right now. And I'll give them some credit here as we get the.
Again, Jim Pat.
Jim Pat O'Dell.
First down.
Real
close.
Close.
O'Dell, once again, the ball carrier. Kyle Barn, one of the Bruins tacklers.
Leading the pack up there in the front of the line is David Null at center. Looks like Brett Schrey or Aaron Schrey is over here at the right guard. Can't really pick up the numbers. Yeah, it is. It is Brett. Brian Lockhart's at the other guard.
Measurement.
Sean O'Dell at the right tackle and Jace the Juice Woodworth in at the left tackle.
Loyal Order of Moose, number 1369 in Robinson, is proud of their community and is pleased to be a sponsor of tonight's broadcast. That's the Loyal Order of Moose, number 1369 in Robinson.
So how much are they short, Jim?
I couldn't see his fingers, but less than a foot.
There's a
third and inches.
There's a number 34 in the backfield.
Third and inches.
They delayed it to Nathan Fiskus,
he got
and he picked up the first down.
I was almost afraid somebody stepped a little quick there.
He had a little bit of a lean going,
uh-huh.
Didn't he?
And now we're down to 6:40 and counting as the Maroons get another first down.
Fiskus, the ball carrier, say Robinson first down.
Sean O'Dell's played a good ball game.
Kyle Bourne on the stop.
We've seen him do a lot of shifting from this side over to unbalanced to the other side. Bryant keeps it, and he manages to get about a yard on the play.
Bryant, quarterback of the ball carrier.
As we're looking at second in about eight with about less than 6.5 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter.
Bryant was hit early on that play, but just ran out of their arms.
Yep. Give it to those seniors. I'm not telling Coach Roach what to do, but... Oh, he almost tripped. Yeah. There's the ball.
Well, the fumble and the Clinton Maroons picked it up right on the 35-yard line.
Kyle Barn on the recovery.
We got
Ryan,
6 minutes,
and
six seconds
to go
here in the ball game, and that's a big turnover.
Ryan stumbled coming out of there, and I don't know if he just didn't get it on.
First and 10 for the Maroon offense.
On Fiskus's hip or not, but it just popped out of there after he got through the line.
Big hole.
Good play by the Maroon defense.
They closed that hole up in a hurry and a pickup of about 4 or 5 yards that time.
Second and five with less than around 5.5 minutes to go.
The ball at the Clinton 40-yard line.
Okay, it's back in the defense's hands. They gotta go do it. Because it's four downs all the time now.
Carter again.
Carter, the Maroon ball carrier.
This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by Leaf Incorporated in the Robinson plant where they manufacture Heath, Milk Duds, Sixlets, and Whopper candies. That's Leaf Incorporated in Robinson.
First Robinson Savings and Loan FA has loan offices available for all your financial needs. The First Robinson Savings and Loan FA is a federal association with deposits insured by the FDIC. Sam's on a keeper, takes it to the 50, and he's nailed.
The ball carrier just inside Robinson territory.
Pickup of about 5 yards on the play. Didn't see who got the tackle, but we're down to second five, and we're under 5 minutes to go.
This is one of these games that's whoever has the ball last may win it, and I don't like the clock.
Come on, defense. Do it.
Sam's the handoff, Carter.
Good
Carter
job.
Stopped
Good
short
job.
Of the
Carter
first
the
down.
Carrier.
It'll be a third and about a yard, maybe a long yard. Let's make it two. Okay, third and two.
They're going to go for it no matter what. The defense is just going to have to suck it up and do it.
Keeps moving that yard marker back a little bit this time.
Well, he picks it up too soon. He didn't wait till the ball spotted.
Offense has a third down play, crowd.
Big play. 4 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter.
In Robinson territory on the 47. right up the middle. Close.
Not sure he got it. I don't think he got it. Because the way the referee was short. No, he didn't.
He's short. He's got to get to the 45.
Here it is.
He didn't make it.
Calling a fourth down.
Fourth and inches. That's where we were a while ago on the other side.
He's got to go that way. He's got to go at least, what, two lengths of the ball on the other side?
Fourth and one.
Yeah, he's got to get it past the 45, inside the 45.
Maroon defense. Robinson's got to play smart defense here. No matter what happens, they got to play. They got to play under control. They didn't get it.
They didn't get it.
Who made the tackle?
Somebody really
Sam's
drove him
nailed
in the ground.
Him,
boy.
Nailed
I mean,
and
somebody blew through there.
They did.
Oh, they marked. Look where they
well,
marked.
They did give him a little forward progress, but that's
and
still not enough
the
to
chains.
Get
chains.
No, they didn't. No.
Yes, they did. They flipped the chains. No.
He's got first down it. Right?
That's.
Yeah.
The ball's laying right on.
They got a marker on the chain on the sideline.
Yeah, so yeah but they moved the chains. He didn't get it.
He's sharp.
Robinson will take
short
over.
Short by a foot.
But they got a marker on the 5-yard marker on the chain, yeah. So in case that
but
happens.
I thought they moved the sticks both on down to the, because I don't think he.
Yeah. Well, they
I don't
have.
Know who. I don't know who came through there, and it'll be neat to watch it.
Well, we're right at 3 minutes, 10 seconds on the clock. Robinson with the ball now. They lead it 28-21.
A couple of first downs and hold on to the ball.
There's been a lot of big plays with that defensive player right there.
That
might
was the
have
biggest.
Been the big one.
Yeah, handoff, second man.
Odell
to the 50.
Odell the ball carrier, Brad Dale.
I went through the whole backfield and still couldn't get out Jim Pat Odell.
Pick up a five.
We're under 3 minutes. Look for those seniors to step forward right now. Take all the time you can. Take the full 25 seconds.
What's the timeout situation with
one
Clinton?
One left for
know?
The Maroon, or the Robinson Maroons, three left for Clinton.
Bryant on a kicker.
Pitched
it back to Jason Fiskus.
Stay in bounds.
Fiskus on the pitch.
Down to inside the
that was
right
a,
at the 30-yard line, about the 31.
That
scared
was a play by Ryan Bryant. I mean, he held, and then at last second he just pitched.
He was being dragged down when he tossed it.
The Yates Berry Corporation is proud to be in Crawford County and is a strong supporter of the youth of the community.
Go ahead.
From the excited E.H. Berry is pleased to help bring you this broadcast, E.H. Berry Corporation in Robinson.
Nathan Fiskus off the left tackle.
Down,
pick up a
giving about 2 yards.
We're not excited, are we, Jim?
Not at all. Not at all. Inside the 30.
Under 2 minutes. Timeout.
Timeout called by Clinton.
The Crawford County Insurance Agency carries all lines of insurance. Call Don Helene, your full-time Pekin agent, at 544-9200 or 592-3553. Good luck, Maroons, from the Crawford County Insurance Agency in Oblong.
Charlie Incorporated CI Systems on the east side of the square in Robinson can provide the highest quality computer systems, service, and support. And they've been serving Crawford County for 15 years. Call Charlie Incorporated CI Systems at 546-5442 for all your computer needs.
Bob's Pizza offers fast, quick delivery on pizzas. Call Bob's Pizza at 544-3378. That's Bob's Pizza in Robinson at 544-3378. Okay, time back in here. As both teams go back on the field, we're looking at 1:55 left to go. Second down for the Robinson Fighting Maroons and about 7 yards to go. Jim Pat in a motion.
How flags down.
I imagine it's a motion penalty
there is
against
a penalty
the Maroons.
Flag on the play.
It was a first down, but I don't know what it was. It's against the Maroons, I imagine it's motion.
Preliminary signal is procedure, Robinson.
They had two or three. Move it. Go
the
ahead.
Hoagland Chiropractic Clinic with Dr. Robert Hoagland and Dr. Todd Hoagland, serving Crawford County for over 25 years, proudly sponsors the Maroons in their effort toward another great year. Hoagland Chiropractic Clinic specializes in industrial injuries, sports injuries, and workman's compensation injuries. Call Hoagland Chiropractic Clinic in Robinson at 544-2064. Okay, second down now in 13 with 1:52 to go. Handoff. Jim Pat Odell picks up about four on the play, bringing up third. If anything, what they're going to do is if they don't make it.
They're forcing Clinton to call their timeouts. Is that two of them?
Yeah, that's their second one.
Okay, I'll do it. The Crawford Memorial Hospital and Foundation would like to thank everyone who came out to the surgical and special care wing dedication. This fall, the foundation is off to a great start. We're at the halfway point of reaching our goal of 200 new foundation members for our fall membership drive. Please help us reach that goal by joining the Crawford Memorial Foundation today. Your membership means a lot. For more information, call the foundation coordinator at 544-3131.
Goodwine Funeral Homes of Crawford County are proud to congratulate the whole team of Fighting Maroons as they continue their journey toward a state football title. By the whole team,
Robinson will be
they mean the players,
the
sportsmanship, the coaches for their guidance,
defense,
managers, cheerleaders, and fans for their support, and all the parents and friends of Robinson High School for being behind the Fighting Maroons the whole way. Once again, Goodwines congratulate you, one and all.
Nathan Fiskus to the left side, makes it to the 20, or makes it to the 30, and that's it.
We're under a minute and a half. I would say the Maroons will just go ahead and go for it.
Here is the importance of a field goal kicker. With the wind behind you,
that's the last time.
1:19 to go.
Now you can really save on Benjamin Moore Paints at Big Buck Building Center in Robinson. Regal Wall Satin Latex Interior Flat Paint is normally $17.55. It's on sale now in over 1,600 custom and ready mix colors for only $15.80 a gallon. For a beautiful matte flat finish, or you can choose enhanced vinyl latex flat paint for a fade resistant flat finish that dries in 1 hour. It's regularly priced at $11.65, but is now on sale for just $10.49 a gallon. Save now with Benjamin Moore Paints, on sale now at Big Buck Building Center in Robinson.
Now that was Clinton's final timeout, is that right?
That's it. Okay.
Well, we're 1:19 on the clock. Now Robinson will be going for it.
A first down wins it. He's going to throw.
He's got
him wide open.
Calvin Fox! Touchdown! From the 30.
30-yard pass play to Fox.
Calvin Fox.
Where's Terry Roach at? He's hanging over the edge. Look at him smile. Look at him smile there on the corner.
Great call by Coach Terry Roach. As Ryan Bryant went back and just laid it right into old Calvin Fox's hand.
Calvin was wide open, gathered it in, and just stepped in the end zone.
You got it. Okay, Tim Lindsay here lining up for the extra point.
1:13 on the clock. Lindsay will have a chance to kick it. 34-21, ball down in the air. Looks all right.
Oh,
hit the upright.
Hit the upright.
Bounce back. All right. 34-21, Robinson leads it. 1:13 to go here in the ballgame.
Well, I'm not going to count too far ahead, but no matter what happens and we win, that game Saturday will be at Robinson. More than likely, it'll start at 1:30, and there's lots of festivities that go on.
And we don't know who it is yet.
And we don't know who it is because it's tied over at Sullivan with Newton. But all I can say is there's lots of festivities that'll go on down there at RHS, and it'll be nice to be in the press box.
I have a question for you. What time will the pork burgers be ready, Tony?
I would say about 11:30.
I'll be
11
there.
Or 11:30, I would say the gates will open at least about 2 hours before and look for about a 1:30 game, but I'm not going to say anything. Just pay attention to what's going on in the newspaper, and you'll hear it.
Lindsay puts his foot into it.
From
taking
the nine.
Inside the 10. And Carter falls, slips.
Ball popped out there, but he was already down.
So
let's see, where is it? About the 21.
Minute nine seconds left.
Well, a game of big plays.
And it's kind of who had the wind is how it ended up tonight.
The whole game, with a very few exceptions, has taken place on the downwind side of the field.
Sam's back to throw, unloads it out, incomplete to the right side.
Robinson's just got to play some basic defense here and get out of Clinton, because Clinton's played an awfully good game. They're a good 8-1 team, and this is a good conference, and we're lucky to get out of here with a win and We just need to play a little bit more fundamentally sound and hold on to the ball, and we can go a long way in this playoffs. But it'll be nice to be home on Saturday.
Sam's to throw again. Again, he looks to the right side.
Complete.
Nichols on the reception, and he's out of bounds.
Stops the clock at 57 seconds. I wish we knew who had knife through and made that tackle on Sam's in that fourth down situation so we could give the kid the proper credit he deserves.
Well,
that was the big play.
It could have been anyone from Jeremiah Whiff, Chad Ryan Smith, Brett Schry. I'm not sure, but Bo Davis could have been any of those guys.
Sam's looks to this side. Uncorks it. Nichols again. He's got a complete.
Keep him in.
And he's down.
Way.
Clock still runs, though. Now they're going
to
stop it.
Yeah, they stop it to move the chains.
The ball at the 40 with a first and 10
Clinton's
for
Clinton.
Clinton's
not giving up. Maroons are making them work, and that's what they got to do as the clock starts here with 50 seconds to go.
Ben Nichols is the man they're going to. He's 6'3", a senior, big target down the middle. All complete. Justin Stone, they got it.
Face mask.
I think the ball will go stay right where it's at. If it isn't, it's a 15 yards down there anyway. Jim Pat went for the interception and missed, and then, you know, good pass.
I'm not, who was a receiver? Limmel?
Yeah.
75? Boy, I tell you, he laid that one right in there.
No, could have
reception
been 70,
is good for 28 yards.
He caught that one like a tight end.
Josh Carter.
Carter? That wasn't Carter.
Yes, it was. 35, not 75.
Face mask call against Robinson.
So
will be added
I don't
on
think Carter looked bigger than what Carter is.
Well, you know, I shouldn't count chickens, but there is 40 seconds, and there could be onside kicks and stuff
like
that.
Oh, yeah, anything can happen.
Anything can happen
in this
here.
Ball game, I believe it.
It's been big plays. The Maroon defense now has to tighten up.
Sam's to throw, goes for the corner.
Looked like that was tipped by Aaron Schry.
Yeah, it did, and Nichols, the intended receiver, and brings up a second down.
31 seconds.
Ball at the 14.
34-21, Robinson Maroons. As we try to sneak out of here with a win.
He's got Nichols split to this side. Back split in the backfield. Sam's will throw it. He looks at Nichols cutting across the inside.
No.
Well, close.
No,
the pass is complete.
Yeah.
But he was down right about the 2-yard line.
First and goal.
First and goal. Sam's.
Touchdown.
Yeah. Touchdown for Matt Carson.
22 seconds. Parsons in for the score from 1 yard out, which
that'll
makes
make it
27 to 34 to 27.
A 1 yard now. Touchdown run for senior Matt Parsons.
As except for the Effingham game, this is the most the Maroon defense has given up all year.
Yeah.
Looks like they're going for two.
Yeah, they'll go for two, I think. That'll take any, make it or not. Carter goes wide in for the two-point conversion.
Carter is in for the two-point conversion.
34-29, and we're back to a five-point spread with 22 seconds
left
on the clock. Well, it ain't over yet.
No, and I shouldn't have said anything.
Where
That's
is the
I
fat
beat,
lady?
I'm going to be quiet.
Well, I'd like to hear her say.
It's going to be an onside kick. The Maroons have got to fall on it.
With the wind, all the kickoffs that direction have almost been onside
been
kicks.
Been onside kicks. Maybe you ought to pop it up. I don't know. I hope they don't. Hope they just kick it onside on the ground. We lay on it and win it.
Clinton can't stop
He's
the clock again.
Sheets no. of paper have you used
These
up.
Clinton Maroons have real, I mean, they haven't yeah. given up. They've really played a gutsy game. And this is a good team.
Well, 22 seconds to go. 34-29. Robinson lays it.
We got our good hands people up front.
Maroons to kick off.
There's Stone. Snyder.
Here it comes.
There it is.
Offsides.
Yeah. Offsides.
Stone picked it up, but it's going to be offsides. They'll walk it back, what, five?
5 yards.
There's a penalty flag.
I don't know. Can you decline this penalty?
I'm not sure. I thought he blew the whistle.
He was blowing
before
a dead before
he kicked.
All right, he
was a dead. It's a dead ball foul.
Okay, so they'll have to walk it off.
Offsides, Clinton.
So we could dunk. I wish we could decline that one.
Well, they'll kick this time from the 35. 22 seconds left.
Watch for it going anywhere.
Odell's about 30 yards deep. You'll never see it.
That's okay. I hope he does it.
Well, they bump it across. A lot of white jerseys are fall on it and protect it. That ought to take care of it.
Took 1 second off the clock on that kickoff.
Maroons will take over now. The first and 10, the ball is going to be placed on the 48-yard line.
Ryan Bryan, all he has to do is drop down.
All right, just start the clock.
Knee dropping time, that's all.
It's over. All I got to say is...
clock's running.
Robinson Maroons should tip their hat to the Clinton Maroons because Clinton played a real gutsy game up here and was inspired a lot by their crowd. They really played a good game.
Heck of a
Let's
ball game. That's
Maroons,
it. Final score, Robinson 34, the Clinton Maroons 29, and a wild ball game here in Clinton.
Good job.
Robinson
both
will win it
go out there
by the final score of 34-29. They advance to Saturday's second round of the IHSA playoffs. We wish Robinson the best of luck in the playoffs and a great season for the Clinton Maroons and their head coach, Chuck Nagel.
You glad you came over, Mark?
Sure.
You going to be up in Robinson Saturday?
Might be.
If you are, look for us. We'll be up in the top of the press box.
All right.
All right. Good deal. See you later.
Now,
thanks for your help.
Now, can I talk about
jump in there
about Saturday?
Jump in there.
Yeah, I mean, it'll be up to the Robinson High School in conjunction with either Sullivan or Newton, but I'm guessing it'll be a 1:30 game. Which is usual for the Maroons on Saturday during the playoffs. I imagine the gates will open somewhere around 11 or 11:30. As a member of the Booster Club, I welcome everybody out to what will be a huge tailgate party, which we have before every home game. Come out because we've got lots of things planned. And come out and enjoy the festivities because it'll be great because you can't beat high school playoff football.
With 1 minute left, Sullivan leads Newton.
Looking for the billboard, what do you do with that?
Pardon?
Looking for the billboard. What'd you do with it?
I don't know.
Put it in your pocket?
Probably.
Everybody's looking.
Do you want to recap the scoring? Do we have that much time?
Sure.
Ron?
Yeah.
No problem. Got it right here.
Time's our own, isn't it?
Yeah, we got all night.
Okay. Wrap it up,
Big plays, y'all. I'll say. Herzog at 4:14 in the third quarter took a 50-yard pass play from Sams. Hinton's kick was good to make it 21-20 Clinton at that point. And that was all the scoring for the third quarter. The fourth quarter, with the Maroons had the wind at their back, they just elected to run, except for one play there. Odell went in from 66 yards out on a run at 10-4-0-4 in the fourth quarter. Stone took the pass for the conversion, make it 28-21 Robinson. 1:13 Fox went in from 30 yards on a pass play from Ryan Bryant, kind of took everybody by surprise. It was a very nice play. Lindsay's kick was no good to make it 34-21. And we all sat here and watched Parsons run it in from 1 yard out at 22 seconds. And Carter, I guess, took the conversion run for 2 points to make the final score 34-29 Robinson. A heck of a ball game.
Well, tonight, the sponsors for tonight's ball game has been Pat Keene Investment Management and Research, Bob's Pizza, Ron's Furniture Store, Crawford Memorial Hospital, the Crawford County State Bank, Pulliam Funeral Homes, the American Legion E.M. Coulter Post 69 in Robinson, Westgate Red and White, P.H. Berry Corporation, the Loyal Order of Moose, number 1369, Charlie Incorporated, Goodwine Funeral Homes, Crawford County Insurance Agency in Oblong, First Robinson Savings Loan, Royal King Supply, Morris Construction, Leaf Incorporated in Robinson, Big Buck Lumber Company, the VFW Post 4549, Dr. David Rotman, Hardee's, and Hoagland Chiropractic Clinic if I can keep a voice going long enough, the Robinson IGA branch of the First National Bank of Avalon, Victor Dana Corporation, the Victor Products Division, and Worldwide Sound and Video Production.
Jim?
Yes.
I'll just get a word in edgewise here. Principal of Robinson High School, Bruce Brockman, stepped in beside me, and I'm just kind of talking to his. Everything
go.
Goes flying.
Let it go. No problem.
And Bruce, just your observations on the game and then a little planning for Saturday, what you can tell us right now.
Well, Tony, I guess the game was a little closer than I had hoped for, quite frankly, but we came out on top, so I'm pleased. We were missing one guy for sure tonight in Charlie Applegate, and I think having Charlie back here is going to help us on Saturday. I'm just pleased that we came out on top. We had a good turnout coming this far away on a chilly night, but I think the guys came through and they did just fine.
Good job. Any ideas on Saturday yet, or is it basically a decision between all teams involved?
We'll see what happens here with the Newton and Sullivan games, and the coaches will get together and they'll decide. We're kind of guessing right now the game time will be around 1:30, but we'll have to check with them and work things out. I would imagine it'll be in that area.
Okay. Thanks, Bruce. Appreciate you coming up for one quick second. Now just so we can find where it's warm.
Okay, thanks. Good talk to you.
Okay, then everybody knows next Saturday where we're going to be in Robinson.
This Saturday,
yes.
We'll be there. We'll be there.
One more thing. This program is copyrighted 1993 by Worldwide Sound and Video Productions. No portion of this program can be reproduced or duplicated in any form. Copies of this program can be obtained by contacting Ron Wheeler at Worldwide Sound and Video Productions at 618-544-7898. I tell you, I'm getting cold.
And it's cold, and I'll say one thing. Congratulations to Clint Maroons on a great season. 34-29 for Robinson, and let's go on to the next one and get the heck out of here.
All right, see you Saturday in Robinson against the winner of the Newton-Sullivan ball game. Shaw, glad to see you back. This is Jim Kincaid along with Tony Schrei, Dwayne Shaw, Ron Wheeler behind the camera. We'll see you Saturday.
There's a little girl out of Boston. Take long to get over me.
a memory. Last night I had a crazy dream about a chick in a black bikini. Oh, she looked so good, she couldn't be real. She must be a magic genie, but she disappeared around the corner. All I saw were three doors and the top of her bikini. I made it through the first door, there was a party going on. I asked about the chick, but what they said was free. Chick-a-boom, chick-a-boom, don't you just love it? Chick-a-boom, chick-a-boom, don't you just love it? Chick-a-boom, chick-a-boom, don't you just love it? Chick-a-boom, chick-a-boom, boom, boom. I found the bottom part behind the second door, which took me to Africa, I presume. This really far-out cat was screaming half crazy. Ball, ball, balloon, ball, balloon, bam, boom. I said, hey, man, cut that jive. And tell me where the chick went. But he looked at me as pleased as could be and said these words, but I wonder what he meant. Chick-a-boom, chick-a-boom, don't you just love it? Chick-a-boom, chick-a-boom, don't you just love it? Chick-a-boom, chick-a-boom, don't you just love it? Chick-a-boom, chick-a-boom, boom, boom. Oh, don't you just love it? Don't you just love it? Don't you love it? Don't you love it? Oh, yeah, don't you love it? Don't you just love it now? I opened the third door, and there she was. And she whispered so sexy and low. Ooh, I tried to do the same and impress her with my style. But why I said this, I never know. Chick-a-boom, chick-a-boom, don't you just love it? Chick-a-boom, chick-a-boom, don't you just love it? Chick-a-boom, chick-a-boom, don't you just love it?
Rainbow shining over.